Salutations, my Fallout lovers. It is Maddie here with week 41 of the Ham Radio Podcast. What are you guys?
Holy shit.
Yeah, what are you guys? We didn't really organize that one right there.
No. I'm Cody. I run the page Vault Dude on Facebook.
I'm Scribe Slindy from Twitter. I post memes. Yeah.
And so Noah is he was working. He got thrown out of work. He was going to be on the podcast. He couldn't be. I don't fucking know.
What did he do to get thrown out of work?
He fucked up at the register or something like that. Oh, really, really stupid. Not his fault. And then Loan forgot. So, yeah.
Forgot?
Yeah. Stop worshipping the damn kangaroo man and go give him some shit.
He's like, wait a minute. After what, 40-some podcasts in a row?
I mean, it's because we fluctuate on Fridays and Saturdays. And, like, we kind of both didn't communicate. But I, like...
Yeah.
Because, like... 3 weeks in a row, Loan's on so early on, like, on a Friday. He's on, like, 2 hours before we start. He's like, hey, man, you getting on? I'm like, what are you talking about? Like, we don't record for, like, 2 more hours. I'm out right now. He's like, oh, shit, my bad. Like, I'm like, dude, where's your head at?
Fucking Australian time, man.
Hey, wake the fuck up, Loan. It's funny because he's literally just waking up whenever he does that. Like, he was, yeah. And, like, he's usually, I think, 9-ish, 10-ish is the time in the morning that he's on. And so, like, he was up at, like, 7 in the morning for a podcast.
Oh,
yeah, he's like, what's up, man? I'm ready to go. I'm like, no, you can go back to bed, dude.
Jump the... Yeah, there ain't no way.
Anyway, down below, you can visit us at Sugar Bombed as well as timestamps for you guys to hop around the podcast and listen to whatever segment you would like to. This is, for those of you who are new and listening to this, this is our standardized podcast that we usually do on a weekly basis. The reason I'm saying that is because the past couple podcasts have been interviews, spoiler casts, no structure really, just kind of shooting the shit. And we have like 4 segments that we go through. So this is actually how the podcast normally works.
Yeah.
So yeah. Anyway, each week we like to bring in guests, as you guys see. And you can be one of those guests by tweeting at us with the hashtag HamRadioTime with your answer to the following question, and it'll be our first news bit that we're going to discuss. Does this large amount of cut content in Fallout 4 bother you at all, or do you feel that it's just a unfortunate part of game development? So that'll bring us into our Bethesda news roundup. Like I said, we're going to talk about this first. What the fuck? There is so much cut content that sounds good.
The underwater shit, people theorize that it's going to be in a future DLC.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, that's possible, I guess. It just makes no sense that it's there right now.
It makes
me like
sad.
An underwater city. People said there. I think I looked at some of the pictures because I think like a guy on Imgur or Imgur. I don't know how it's pronounced.
I think it's Imgur,
but I call it Imgur.
I say Imgur. Whatever.
Yeah.
Picture
website.
There.
Yeah, picture website A.
you know, he was showing like everything around. It looks like a detailed area.
Yeah,
and a lot
which is why it might be in a DLC later. And
yeah,
like, now
wasn't there a door or something like a building you could go into?
I'm not sure, but wasn't there a harpoon gun?
Yeah, they cut,
there was a harpoon
okay.
gun that's in the files.
Yeah,
yeah, that might be DLC too, though. That might be coming
like
with that
is,
underwater part.
Is Bethesda like holding out on us here? Like
that's what I was just thinking.
Bethesda,
that they never do that, right? Call of Duty and stuff. They'll make maps and then they'll hold it back from you and then make you pay for them later. But Bethesda's never known for doing that stuff. So,
and like, I think everyone's...
Yeah, no, that's not like them.
Everyone's... I'm guilty of this, by the way. Like, their blind fanboyism almost kind of is making them not think, like, oh, Bethesda might be stuffing shit in the files for later, you know?
Yeah.
And
now,
Destiny's a classic case of that happening. You had DLC that was locked out. Like, it's content they use for DLC, but you couldn't actually access the areas. They just kept it on the disc to save size. So while that is a possibility that it was a save download size, it still sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah. And, I mean, maybe they're not doing that. It could be they have that harpoon gun already done and everything, but maybe they don't have that area really, like, maybe it's just a shell that you're looking at, and there's way more to it than that they're working on right now.
I mean,
so
I think of it this way, though. This is my imagining, too. They also cut a sea monster quest out of the game. I forgot what it was called, but it was in the same post where you hunt a sea monster in that big ocean out there.
Oh,
that's upsetting. I want that.
So it's like,
stop
they were probably,
telling me these
I'm
things.
Saying they were probably going to do like a sea monster quest, and that's probably how you got the harpoon gun. It's like, hey, go in the water, hunt this fucking thing. And then it was all in that underwater section of all those buildings and stuff.
That's so cool.
I cry every time.
Right? Like, it's so disappointing almost, you know?
Yeah.
we have to hope they held it for like reasons of quality or something, because maybe it wasn't done by the time they needed to ship and they didn't want to put out a half-finished quest. And I mean, yeah, this game has really its issues, but...
Yeah, we can be really hopeful and think it's going to be in DLC. So.
Yeah, and I mean, that could just be us justifying, and yeah. I'm not going to say that Bethesda's not guilty of cutting corners, but I'd like to think that it was for good reasons.
Also, though, it's not a huge deal if it is in DLC. Like, because if you're going to buy DLC, you're probably going to buy the $30 season pass, right? So yeah, you're not paying more, really. You're going to get all the DLC no matter what. Yeah. So, I mean,
and this game already has so much in it. It's not like a game like Destiny where it launched with almost fucking nothing and you have to have the DLC to make it bigger.
No, that is entirely true. You could at least this get 100 hours. This game has so much. At least.
Oh, at easy. I'm at like 64 and I haven't beat the game.
Yeah. That's kind of like the average I've heard is between like 60 and 80 for your first playthrough. I'm like just scratching 100 and I'm like, I'm going to be totally honest. Like, I really don't have much else to do. Like, I think I have a couple of side quests left, but that'll barely push me to 100 hours, I think. It's weird when because I was talking to a couple of friends about it. It's almost like Fallout 4 is like smaller than Skyrim because they try to do all these faction quests for the main story. Mm-hmm. That there's not that many like side quests. I mean, it's obviously longer than Fallout 3, which was like 50 hours, I guess you could say.
Right.
But
the problem with the side quests is they're all very very cut and paste.
Yeah.
But some of them are still like, a good game. Not hating on it.
Yeah, but like some of them are, like there's really cool ones. Like the USS Constitution one is fucking awesome.
I still haven't done that one yet. Is it worth it?
It is so worth it.
No, that one's so cool. I actually have 115 hours.
Really?
Right now. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, but there's like, more to discover. I still have a bunch of rares to find and stuff. But like,
I have so much to do. I spend most of the game. I have like almost every location discovered because I spend most of the game just like, oh, there's a spot over there. I just run to it and then I don't really explore it much. I like have it discovered, then okay, well, I'm gonna go run to this one now and then I'll go back later. And
I have a couple locations like that that like I jotted down. Like I literally have a piece of paper that says locations I need to return to.
I have a notepad that shows me tells me where all my when early in the game I didn't have the lockpick skill, I have all the where the locks that I couldn't open were.
Oh, gosh.
I just console command that shit, I'm not gonna lie. I
get all like annoyed with myself. I'm like, why didn't I invest in lockpick? Like, that's why with Fallout 4, I just right off the bat, I'm like, lockpick science. I'm not being locked out of anything. And
dude, for the first like 10 or 11 levels, I didn't know you could scroll down on the perk chart. Because I was sitting there scrolling and using my down arrows and nothing was happening. You just have to move the mouse cursor down. That's so annoying.
Whoops.
I didn't know that.
The only reason I knew that was I had a since I got the Pip-Boy edition, I got like the poster perk chart, and I laminated that shit and have it up on my wall, so I knew.
But. Oh, I knew there was more perks. I just thought they were holding out on me until a higher level.
While we're talking about cut content, there's more, ladies and gentlemen. There's more.
Mm.
There's an arena. You guys know the combat zone, Kate. That's where you meet Kate.
Yep.
According to a post, there was more audio files found that showed that there was supposed to be an arena that you were supposed to be able to compete in. There was a room in the basement that you would rise up in and you'd fight against raiders and there'd be an end prize.
That's so cool. That's like in New Vegas, the Thorn.
Yeah.
I didn't even find the Thorn until like my ninth playthrough. Yeah. I don't know what
I'm saying. Everyone talks about the Thorn and like on YouTube.
I'll be honest, it's hidden. It's pretty hidden.
Yeah. It's pretty hidden.
Just this one little sewer.
I know, but like everyone talks about it and I like go in there and I'm like, okay, I'm like this. Yeah. I didn't know this existed.
Yeah,
you guys do know that there's a combat arena in Fallout 3 too, right?
Yeah, there's. Well, I know there's one in the pit.
The pit. Yeah.
No. Yeah. No. It's in the What's the DLC where you fight the hillbillies and it's really hard?
Point Lookout.
Point Lookout. There's one in Point Lookout too.
Really?
It's up in the top corner. It's a cave system. You gotta fight ghouls, and if you beat it, you get an axe that does like triple damage to ghouls or something. Jeez. It's insane.
So, this arena has been cut out, and so now we have, like, this underwater thing cut out, the arena cut out. Like, let's say Bethesda did this, we'll give them the benefit of the doubt. They did this intentionally so that they could do free updates down the line that would give us little extra things to do. Does that sound better than having it all at launch?
Yes.
I like that, yeah.
It keeps us coming back, because if you see everything, you're like, I don't want to come back. But if there's a trickle of new shit like they did with Skyrim, like mounted horseback combat, stuff like that... Mm-hmm. It keeps people wanting to stay in Fallout.
Yeah, I agree. See, I think the best formula, and I know they're totally different games, but I think like the best formula that Bethesda should try to stick to is like GTA Online. Like, yes, holiday absolutely. Updates, like, adding new shit all the time that's, like, innovative right. and fun. Like, I don't play GTA.
Except not the heists, because they dropped the ball with heists.
Yeah, holy
the
shit.
The weird thing about that, though, like, they never did that for Fallout 3. Fallout 3, it shipped, the game is there, they updated it, and they gave you DLC, but there was nothing, like, they didn't add anything mm-hmm. to it for free. And
that's what they started doing that with Skyrim, really.
Yeah.
The thing that kind of, I guess, irks me is because there were mods for Fallout 3 New Vegas. More so Fallout 3 I want to talk about, though, with cut content. And it was just, like, weapons. But with Fallout 4, it seems like locations, quests.
Yeah, like
kind
big,
of, yeah. Yeah, like an arena, like underwater location and underwater sea monster quest. I don't get it. Like, why yeah. cut that stuff? And the reason we're specifically asking why is because they said they took their time for so much on this fucking game.
And that's 7 years. I don't want to accept the fact that they didn't have enough time to do this, because even Pete Hines, he said that Bethesda Game Studios, they pick when they announce the game and they release the game.
Yes.
It's not like they don't let the publisher do that. They literally, when they're done,
they're done.
And that's it. Yeah, but like the game studio itself, Todd Howard, he'll decide when it's all done. And so there's not a good reason, really, for press for time.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, there's exactly that. There's no, from what we've been told, any logical reason as to, okay, they were pressed. Okay, the publisher was like, enough's enough. It's like they...
Yeah, it's not like all their games. Vegas.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's like they decided, okay, pack it, ship it, let's do this.
Yeah.
Well, that, and you have to remember, they also, packed it like a month and a half before a release or something. Maybe that's too big of a number, but I know
like
they also packed
weeks,
it far before.
Yeah, they packed it. I want to say Great War. That's what it was. Great War. So about 2.5 or so weeks.
Yeah,
that's about normal. Yeah, I mean, it's just you know. And on top of that, the final thing, which we won't go into detail so that we don't spoil anything for anyone else. They also cut an ending, which was considerably better. Considerably better than
I
the
cry
original
every time.
Ending. Really not. I guess everyone calls it an ending because it's a part of the end of the game, but it's really just like a lead up to the normal ending.
Yeah,
but it could have drastically.
It would have been.
It could have added so much choice.
Better.
Oh gosh, it was a killer to hear it, and like the proof was in the pudding because like someone went in and found like complete audio files of this ending.
Wait,
that's
for
not
real?
In there on
Holy
accident.
Shit.
Yeah. So,
and
like. It's weird that it's still in there, though.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. And people are like, well, is it going to be patched in DLC? I'm like, you know, I get it's Bethesda, but why are we settling for this? Like, this is ridiculous now, in my opinion.
Yeah.
You know, I can get like the quest, whatever, but like little things like the arena, the ending, like, come on. Really?
Yeah, yeah.
And, now
and the arena seems like something so easy.
Yeah.
That seems like something that is not big to make, but...
Well, and another thing you have to remember, and this isn't me defending it, I think shit should be in there, but there's also the possibility that some of this stuff that they cut it out because it just didn't work.
No, that's
and
totally
it would have taken
possible.
Too much effort to remove it entirely from the files.
Yeah, yeah.
And then, like, and I mean, that's a possibility, and some of it could be that, and some couldn't, but...
And they might just leave it there for some modder to take it and throw it in the game, actually, and make it an official mod, but I feel like... one of my bigger fears with Bethesda is that they'll end up relying on the community too much to fix their games. And that's, like, already a trope. Like, people say Bethesda relies on the community to fix their broken fucking games. And it's like, well, I don't think
so. Yeah, that's already a pretty commonly spoken thing.
Yeah, so I just don't want them to kind of be like, well, yeah, you think so? Okay, let's do that then. Let's fuck this. Like, let's not finish this. Let them do that.
Let's just make a game full of half-finished shit and the fans will take care of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, they could easily do that. That's the sad part.
Yeah, that's scary if you think about it too much.
I mean, oh, God, all this cut content, it gets me salty.
So
yeah, me too. Like, especially that underwater quest thing. Like, that sounds really...
Yeah, right? That sounded really cool to me.
And the ending. Oh,
yeah.
Geez.
I mean, and then a lot of people were thinking, like, on top of, like, did they have enough time is because... I don't think the amount of water they have on the map is that bad, but some people were saying that could have been land, and is that why there are, like, buildings submerged underwater to, like, make up for, like, part of the map that was deleted or some shit?
Huh.
I personally don't agree with that, but I can see where they're coming from at the very least.
I don't know. I don't think so either. I don't think you can just literally, like, cut, paste, delete a map, you know? I don't think you can.
No, I don't think it works like that.
Yeah, so...
Well, and I'm perfectly happy with the water-to-land ratio, as it may.
Well, it also works in the map. Like, as you start progressing towards the southeast, like, it gets more marshy, there is more water, and then there is the ocean, obviously. So,
yeah, exactly. Yeah.
It's like, why the fuck would Bethesda all of a sudden just, no, let's not put the ocean in the game?
Yeah. I'm sure people won't question why, you know, the Atlantic Ocean isn't there. That's not that important.
So, moving on to our next thing, because maybe this could help with preventing cut content in the future.
Hello?
What's up?
Hi.
Oh, sorry. It sounded like you cut out for a second. That must be my
hand. Oh, yeah. I'm like in the middle of this all yours. Hello? I thought you like picked up your phone in the middle of the podcast. I'm like, is this guy serious?
It sounded like you died. Like, because you've petered off. You got, it could, I was like, did he have a fucking heart attack in the middle of the podcast? Awkward.
What I was saying was that to prevent this future cut content, not specifically, but I'm saying this could be a opportunity for Bethesda. They have expanded, opening a brand new Bethesda Game Studios office in Montreal.
This is
Ooh.
Exciting.
This is like the best news ever. And
yeah,
Bethesda, and now it's a thing, because back when I did like news updates for any time Bethesda took a shit, they'd do something to spite me. They'd say something of the opposite. They'd prove me wrong. I'd have to make a second follow-up video like 10 minutes later after releasing it. Something like that happens. They did it again. I make a video. I'm like, because I was responding to something we'll talk about later. I'm like, yeah, Bethesda could only do this if they opened a new studio. Literally, the impossible happens 2 days later. We're proud to invite a new Montreal studio into our family. I'm like, fuck. Are you kidding?
That's so ridiculous, too. Like, just the thought that they actually expanded.
Yeah, right?
That's so, like, not them at all.
Yeah, no, that is the last thing I expected.
Yeah.
I think crazy. It's because they can't handle next gen on their own. And I think a lot of things in Fallout 4, as great as the game is, points to that.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree.
I'm with you on that one, man.
Yeah, because I think they realize, okay, we can get this done. They made a big game, a good game at that, you know. Great game, even, if you want to, whatever. But I think they realized that they could have done a lot better if they had a bigger team. And they realized a bit too late.
Yeah, people are, I feel like they did cut out a lot of things that were in the older games. Even the karma system. Mm-hmm. Little things like that that people really, really liked. Like, even though the karma system didn't affect much, they just liked being penalized for stealing something. But now you can really just steal anything and it doesn't really matter at all.
I mean, it was such a... I liked the karma system until I did like a trophy hunt and got the platinum trophy for Fallout 3, where I realized how easy it is to break the system, where I became the saint of the wasteland until the most evil piece of shit just by opening Moira Brown's terminal and closing it. Not even hacking it. So like, no one was attacking me or anything. I just kept opening it. It's like, you lost karma. You lost karma. You lost karma. Holy shit, you are so badass, man. You are opening that terminal.
Same with giving the guy water and becoming the like savior of the wasteland.
Yeah, they definitely should have improved
on
meme. It.
That is a meme. It is so broken.
I know. Yeah. I mean, obviously everyone who says, well, if it's broken, they could fix it and innovate on it. But I think the karma system was kind of it was better just to cut it out and let the player decide what was good and what was bad for them.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Tell them. But as for this new studio, do you think this is going to be... Because they said that there's over 40 industry veterans in this studio. For console and mobile development.
Oh, gosh.
Do you guys think that they're going to be working on just mobile games?
I hope not.
Oh, man.
I hope not.
That's horrible.
I'd be so disappointed. What?
They need to hire Hideo Kojima.
Yeah, Hideo Kojima.
Kojima. Oh, that'd be legendary.
You know, run that studio.
Imagine. Okay. Holy fuck.
Get confirmed.
I'm pretty sure it's at the end of the year his contract is up. And
big fuck.
We're gonna find out.
I think he's gonna flip the double birds to the games industry.
Oh,
like,
dude.
Fuck all.
Yeah.
Really?
Guys have just shit on me.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, what is with Enclave vertebrates just crashing into the ground every time I see them? Like,
well,
have you guys
Brotherhood.
Seen that?
Brotherhood for vertebrates now. Because,
seriously, that's like the eighth time I've watched a vertebrate just fly into a bridge and explode.
Yeah, people, I'm sorry, that whoever flies the fucking vertebrates in Fallout 4 are idiots. They stay around until they get shot the fuck down. Like,
I saw a video.
You're gonna die.
Yeah, I saw a video. This guy was talking to that one cult leader. I don't know, I can't think of where he is, but he's like runs this cult. They were just talking, having a conversation, and the vertebrate crashed on top of them, and like a Brotherhood jumped out of the fucking vertebrate and was like You know, let's kill him. And like, you know, and they were just having a conversation.
You know that video that like people have, like Kate's like, it's nice to know that you always have my back, and then she gets like jumped or something like that.
Dude,
yeah, no, wait, what?
That literally happened to me. I'm talking to MacReady. He's like, I don't know, man. It's just great to have you as a friend and know that you're always looking over my shoulder. And I shit you not, a ragstag comes in. He's like, ooh, like that, and just barrels him over.
That's hilarious.
I'm like, oh shit. Like,
no, but I uploaded that video with Kate getting hit.
That was you?
Yeah.
That was your video?
Yeah.
Your game?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Like, the man, the legend.
Yeah, no, it has like 500,000 views on my Facebook page or something like that.
Holy fuck.
Wait, oh my god, I'm looking this up right now. I'm pausing the game and looking this up.
That's amazing. I can't believe that. You're like, that's my video.
Oh. Wait, it's on your Facebook page, you said?
Yeah.
Wait, what's your Facebook page?
Vault Dude.
Vault Dude? All right.
Yeah. On the left, there should be a videos tab.
Perfect. Also, by the way, I found Maddie, you know the concept art that came out and there was those bombers in the airport?
Yes.
I actually found one of those bombers just now.
Really?
Yeah, I had no clue, but no, I found one. It's like crashed. It's not as big as they looked in the concept art, but I was like, oh, that's where that went.
Yeah, well, speaking of that, I was thinking about the concept art earlier. Where's the crossbow, man? I was so
hoping Fallout 4
would have a crossbow.
Wait, does the crossbow look like the harpoon gun?
Yeah, it could have been. I mean, a lot of people were saying it's either a harpoon gun or a crossbow, but I was just thinking to myself, like, dude, that's a Fallout gun. That's a makeshift gun. A bow and arrow or something? I wish. Holy DLC. Crap. DLC. Welcome to today's Asian gaming, where anything we want is instantly DLC.
Yep.
Did you make me cry?
So, all right. This expansion studio, do you think it's going to be... Let's say that, you know, they got a little bit of the team working on mobile and then console. Do you think this is a standalone studio that is going to build up and make games on their own? Or do you think they're just going to be like, a support studio and help Bethesda make games in DC? Because they only have 40 people. That's the thing that threw me off. And obviously they're hiring.
Yeah, I think that makes a lot of sense, actually.
Yeah, no, I totally support that.
So
I sent that video in the chat.
I honestly, I'd almost prefer, me personally, if they were just the support studio.
Yeah.
To lend out, like, hey, you're a little short staffed. You need some extra stuff developed. We'll take that over here.
Yeah.
No, I think that would be a lot better because then I definitely feel like their 4 to 5 year development cycle is.
Ugh. Well, I mean, that's the one good thing that comes out of this. No matter what happens, I think we can all agree that this will speed up development time.
Definitely.
There's no excuse. So in about, you know, someone made a good point though. A lot of their games came out within like 3 years. You look at, I think Oblivion came out in like 06. Well, here, we'll start at Morrowind. Everyone likes to start at Morrowind. Morrowind was 2003, right? Then Oblivion was 2006, so that's 3 years. It could have been 2005, but Bethesda didn't want to be like a launch title or something like that.
Yeah.
Then Fallout 3 somehow gets done in like 2 years.
Well, they announced that in 2004.
Oh yeah,
announced that they were making.
But I mean, a lot of it was just cut and pasted Oblivion, which isn't a bad thing. But it wasn't like they redesigned the engine or anything. Kind of like they did with New Vegas.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then you have from Fallout 3 to Skyrim. That's 3 years. So it kind of seems like the trend was 3 years until Fallout 4. It was that extra long.
Yeah, I never thought of that.
Yeah, and so they said that they started pre-production for Fallout 4 and like right after Fallout 3 in 2009.
Yeah.
So say they're working on like Elder Scrolls 6. How long do you think it's going to be then? You know, just hypothetically speaking, like if it's a quicker development time, does this mean we can expect a Bethesda Game Studios game like 2.5 to 3 years? Because now they're familiar with the technology they're working with. They have more people working.
I want to say 2016 is a, or not 2016, 2017 is a stretch, but 2018 definitely, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, for sure. Well, are we talking a new Elder Scrolls or a like Fallout expansion in the vein of?
No, I'm saying like a new Elder Scrolls.
Oh, yeah, I think 2018, 2019 is the latest.
See, my thing is that like they should just do this. Hand off Fallout to Obsidian. It's almost clear now. I love Fallout 4 and Fallout 3. But it's almost clear now that, like, after Fallout 4 came out, everyone's like, we want Obsidian to make Fallout.
Yeah.
Hand off Fallout to Obsidian. Let them try it again. While we do that,
not forever, but just at least for a game and see how they do.
Yeah, not forever. Go back to your bread and butter with Elder Scrolls. Give them that next-gen treatment. From there, let Obsidian continue working on Fallout. Make a new IP. Work on that. See if that works. While Fallout still lives on with a studio that people want Fallout from. The original creators of Fallout. Granted, Chris Avellone's not there, but most of the fathers of Fallout are still at
Obsidian. Although I do admit I would miss the visual narrative because I feel like Bethesda does visual narrative a lot better than
Obsidian. Oh, gosh, yeah. It's everywhere in Fallout 4. I love it.
I'm still finding little bits and pieces of just notes next to skeletons and shit. Like,
I love that. New Vegas fucking each other.
Oh yeah, I love how you can without knowing who made Fallout 4, you know if you just played it blind that it's a Bethesda game and not an Obsidian game. Exactly. You can tell easily.
That is not a diss on New Vegas.
Yeah, it's just like Fallout 3.
It didn't have the atmosphere that Fallout 3 had.
No, it didn't. It definitely didn't. The thing that Obsidian gets right is, obviously, I love the ability to kill everyone. Like, yes. They have that they don't have the Essentials tag, basically, that Bethesda has on every other character in the game.
I think the issue with a Bethesda game is not, they make great games. If they just removed one thing, I think it would fix a lot of their problems. Let us make mistakes, you know? They seem so, and let us miss things. Because they should know by now, we're going to come back and play it over and over and over.
Right.
So.
And the fun of playing it again is finding stuff that you missed the first time.
Exactly. So why not let us, it almost removes more restriction. And everyone talks about how great and free these Bethesda games are. Wouldn't they be more great and free if it was you can fucking shoot whoever you want. You can do whatever, literally do whatever you want. In Fallout 2, I always look to that as granted, it's really old, but that's one of the most free games because you can literally just talk to some random dude in a town and just curse him the fuck out, basically, and he'll pull a gun on you, you know, and that's, I like that
it's
freedom.
Real.
Because even though I'll laugh and reload my game and not really progress forward, that's still a moment I was able to enjoy because I was I just fucking told this guy to suck a dick, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, something about Todd, he said... with the dialogue system, that how it's completely free and you can move around while and you're not locked into it. But he also said you can shoot him in the face if you want. And to me, when he said that, I thought, well, that means that they removed the essentials tag and you can kill anyone.
That's what I thought too.
That's what that really makes
sense. That's clearly not the case, though.
You cannot kill so many people.
I know. It's anytime I do a rare guide, I shoot up all of Sanctuary.
Yeah.
And all the time, Stir just goes down, stands back up. I'm come on.
Why is he so essential? He's not essential to anything.
Yeah.
he shows you how to build stuff.
That's what I'm saying. Okay, say I kill him. Oh, I can't build settlements. Too fucking bad.
Yeah. But you can. He just shows you barely shows you how to.
Yeah, no, the settlements are not well explained.
Yeah. Thank God for YouTube.
And I also, I don't know. Don't think it's so well executed.
You know who I wish you could fucking kill? June Long and Marcy, I think those are their names.
Oh my
god.
Those
two assholes. Yeah.
June's always or John, he's always I wish I could have done something. And then Marcy's such a bitch. I'm who are, I don't even remember you people. I know I saved you from Concord, but
Who the fuck are you?
Get the fuck
everybody
out of
hates Mama Murphy.
I do like the crazy old lady though, because she actually I talked to her and she gave me some stuff that made my mission so much easier. If you haven't talked to her yet and you're playing the game, go talk to her and get her to read the future for you.
Mama Murphy. It's cool. Yeah,
she's almost made my job so much easier.
She's almost a free guide. You just go hey, here's some trucks, and then she literally tells you
and then she complains that she wants
she removed two boss fights for me by giving me hints on them.
That's awesome. Anyway, new studio. Right.
There's a new studio.
On top.
Is there any final thoughts on that? You guys think this...
No mobile games. Just...
Yeah.
No.
I mean, one thing you have to consider, though, is that the thing that concerns me most is that the guy who's heading this studio is the guy who led the project for Fallout Shelter for both iOS and Android. So when they see console and mobile development, that's what they're focusing on? Fuck, man. Fuck.
Yeah, it's...
And it's not Elder Scrolls Legends. That's what I thought, but that's a totally different studio. So
we just don't need mobile games.
Yeah,
ever. I hate them.
I understand. Fallout Shelter was fun. That's the only time I've ever that's the only time I've ever played a mobile game. And Bethesda should know their audience by now. We don't play mobile games. We play big fucking games that hook us for hours.
Now, they might be looking at this, though. Like, Candy Crush is worth over $5 billion.
Yeah. Activision's also an idiot.
Yeah. Activision bought
Candy Crush. What the fuck were they doing when they bought them for real?
That's crazy. So they might be looking at those numbers, though, and, you know?
I just hope Bethesda doesn't join the free-to-play with all of the fucking ridiculous amounts of things to purchase mobile crowd, because I'd like to think they're better than that. And I still have, they're like one of the only studios I have a shred of faith in. And if they did that, I'd just be destroyed.
I agree. Yeah. I mean,
but it's hard to say no to the money. That's the thing. Like,
yeah, I mean, we split them up. So let's say, you know, they have 40 right now. We have 20 going to console, 20 going to mobile. Cause like, now, you know, assigning like 10 people to mobile, that doesn't make sense in my opinion.
Yeah.
Unless these mobile games are really easy to program. I could be wrong.
Yeah.
It just doesn't make sense. So you split them up. So then it's clearly got to be like a support studio in that regard.
Yeah. How much do you think that unless they're specifically doing mobile development, that's not enough to do any major project on a Bethesda scale.
How much do you think they're going to expand? Name on. Because also the one in DC was hiring as well. Like, how much more do you think they're going to expand? I know they said like DC was 110 people with Fallout 4 or so, and then
DC,
the one that like Todd Howard studio,
Maryland.
Yeah, I don't know why I say DC.
Yeah,
it's like I think of the page, whatever.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I've been saying that the whole time. So
I don't know. It probably they're probably not hiring a lot. That's what I would think. They've always talk about how they're so close-knit and everything, and
now they're hiring more. Like, I feel like, I wanted to say they were going for, like, 180 or so people.
They were at, like, 110, right? So
110, then plus, like, the 40 they have now.
Yeah, that's a lot.
That's about 150. So, yeah, I'm gonna go with, like, 170. I'm gonna lower it. 170, 165.
Yeah. That sounds reasonable. Like I just it's a big step.
Yeah. I mean, when you think of it this way though, they made such big games with 110 people. Do they really need that many more people to like
it's crazy.
Iron it out?
Yeah. It's got to just be the time. If
it makes the game better, I'm not going to complain.
Yeah. Oh god. Yeah. Like they made so much money on Fallout 4, they can afford to
Do whatever the fuck they want like, now.
They should really keep expanding in my opinion. Holy shit.
Although Call of Duty outsold them, which makes me sad.
Not surprised. Black Ops 3 isn't that bad. I still enjoy it.
No. We beat them out opening weekend, but our slowed down and Black Ops 3 picked up.
Well, it's Black Ops 3.
Yeah. It's actually, I will say that much, and I hate to admit it. It's really not. It's Treyarch. Right. That's probably why.
Treyarch, exactly.
I love Treyarch. Black Ops 2 is my favorite Call of Duty game after
They make a good Call of Duty.
They really do. I don't know what it is. I think it's just they listen, because they didn't like put in the commando lunge or any stupid bullshit. Like
everything Activision has done since like Modern Warfare 2 has just been
awful.
Like, what the fuck are you doing?
Yeah, Modern Warfare 1 was great. Yeah. Modern Warfare 1 was great. Modern Warfare 2 was all right. So and after that, I'm just like, no.
Well, so many people are like, oh, dude, I haven't had fun with COD since MW2. I'm like, how'd you have fun with that game? That game was so broken to shit from launch onward.
So broken. But
remember the stinger glitch?
Yeah. I was formerly known as Glitcher 27, and I remember doing glitching
videos. I've seen
videos.
The videos.
Yeah, and I remember doing glitching videos, and there was one where it was the care package glitch. I don't know how you discover this. You pull the pin for the care package. You climb over a wall. You just press A while holding the pin out. And you throw down your care package, like smoke grenade, right after that. And guess what? You don't lose your care package if one comes in. So for like weeks on end during MW2, it literally just all you see, care package incoming, care package incoming. Like literally all you see fucking planes flying all over the place and shit. I'm like, oh my gosh.
God damn.
And then kill streaks are all over the place. It was so stupid. I'm like, how do you fuck that up?
And the 10th procedure lobbies was.
Oh, that was the best. My friend was a scumbag.
Oh yeah, no,
totally
we went into
the kid. He was like, yeah, I have a JTAG, dude. I'll give you a 10th prestige. And kid sent him 1600 Microsoft points. And my friend's like, well, I'm not doing it. I'm like, you're an
dude,
ass.
I have videos on YouTube of like super old videos on a different channel of my JTAG because I had one like an asshole, like. I will never show anyone them though.
what is a JTAG? I gotta ask, what's a JTAG?
It's a modded Xbox that you can host. Well, you can do a lot of different things.
Because I mean, I got Prestige 10 server. I got
that was how though was with the JTAG Xbox. They can go online and mod servers and stuff, and it's
oh my god.
It would make for some fun lobbies, but
yeah, the AC-130
yeah.
fully automatic was pretty cool.
Oh my gosh. So moving on from Fallout 4 to Call of Duty Impromptu. 2. Let's talk about something a little different for a second. Where's Dishonored 2? Anyone know?
That game?
MIA.
Wait, what game are you talking about? Is that like a fucking Konami game? What?
Yeah.
But seriously, they said spring 2016. So
that's not far off.
Actually, you know what? Hold on. Let me Google it, because I want to say it's. I thought it was earlier. Like, they didn't put a release date on it, I believe.
Yeah, of course not. But
well, yeah, that's smart though, because they don't want to lock themselves in.
It's very strange.
I can almost guarantee it's going to be fucking delayed.
If it makes the game better, I'm okay with that. Dishonored is one of my. It is my all-time favorite stealth game. So.
Oh yeah, yeah. I agree with that.
Probably the best stealth game. I don't think I've played it a better one. Honestly.
That's interesting because Wikipedia is saying Q2 2016.
So summer?
Yeah, summerish. Oh, dude, how am I going to balance that with Persona? Oh, gosh. Fuck me.
Fucking weeb.
Fucking shit. let's see here. Dishonored 2 pre-orders ongoing for PS4 and Xbox One. Expected to be released in spring. So. They don't have that much time to show this game. That's what I'm saying. Like, all the game shows are done. Like, and if it comes out, we'll say, like, May, early June, because that's technically still spring.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The only shows I can think of are, like, a couple of PAX shows. But, like, they're not... I feel like it's going to be delayed. I just get
this. Maybe. Game. They might... I don't know. They might not... I was going to say, no, they're definitely confident. I was going to say they might not be very confident in it, so they're not going to hype it much, but...
I mean...
Dishonored 1 sold really well, apparently.
Yeah.
Dishonored, I still play Dishonored 1. I beat it, like, 10 times.
I love that game. Yeah. Man. One game I played, like, 3 times over before I even switched the game. Because I did, like, a normal playthrough, then I did, like, a non-lethal playthrough, and then, like, a complete ghost playthrough. Oh, man. Because, like, by that point, you have the game memorized when you just obsessively play it for, like, weeks on end.
Yeah, yeah.
So good. But, like, I just want to, you know, I'm thinking to myself, they're not giving themselves as much time to, like, breathe where they're going to be. They revealed it just in June. Haven't talked about it all this year. You know, which makes sense, though, because of Fallout 4. But, you can see that even Doom kind of surfaces above the water a little bit and, like, does some things. Like, here's the alpha. Here's some new trailers. You know, here's a celebration because it's this anniversary for Doom or whatever. And, like, people are still excited for the game. It's like, are they waiting to, like, shove Doom out and then Dishonored 2, like, in this small, tight space?
I don't know. It's really weird.
When does Doom come out?
March, I think.
Shit, I feel like I've been hearing about that game for like 3 years and it still hasn't come out.
Yeah, because it got rebooted. It looks good.
It looks fantastic.
Oh, no, I saw the gameplay at E3. It looks fucking amazing.
Like,
Doom release date. Hold on, I'm looking it up right now. It says 2016? Spring 2016.
Huh. The feel of the game, like, shooting-wise, is probably going to be a lot like Fallout 4 because id Software... is who helped Bethesda with the shooting aspect of.
So why couldn't they have made Fallout 4 with the id Tech engine? Because holy shit!
Oh gosh, I don't think they could handle that type of game. You think?
I don't know if they could handle it, but I wish they could.
I feel like they'll never move on from there.
yeah, I can't imagine them with like a fucking fully polished engine.
Like, the day Bethesda uses a modern engine is the day that I don't exist.
They're on like the upgraded creative engine.
Been around, and the creation engine's just an updated Gamebryo engine.
Exactly!
Work with what you know, I guess, but come on, guys.
But people don't realize, like, and I even slipped my mind even to this very moment, I just remembered, it was like, people always forget that modding's such a big part of the community. Like, I feel like that's part of it, you know, that everyone's like, oh, I love modding so much. God, Bethesda, you have no fucking engine already. It's like, well, there's probably a good reason why, and probably because of the creation engine. Then again, you have people making mods for The Witcher 3, so it's like, you know, maybe it's time to move on. Didn't they trademark like a void engine or something? Like, I think, yeah, I can almost guarantee they're working on a new one.
I remember you jumped on that when they said it.
Yeah, because I was just like, okay, next gen, let's go.
Next gen, let's. Wasn't that like, because I know I was on the second podcast you ever had, and I think we talked about it in that podcast.
Yeah.
Maybe it was the one after, but I remember we actually talked about it because it had just happened.
Yeah, because like they're definitely working on a new engine.
Well, we can't even say anything bad about the engine right now, though. Like, they, in Fallout 4, I personally have experienced very little glitches.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Everyone's like, God, this game's broken.
It's polished.
Like, yeah, it's better than Skyrim, that's for sure. Shit.
They got it down. Also, if you're going third person, the animations are great.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Your character looks fantastic.
Yeah,
so,
I agree. No, I totally agree.
They also have, like, John Cena moves, too, that the...
yeah, I just watched that video.
Yeah. Yeah. On arms. Oh, yeah. My gosh.
That's, like,
I was
hilarious.
Amazing. No, I mean, we sound like fanboys, but, like, I thought I was the only one. Like, everyone's, like, tweeting at me, oh, God, Maddie, this bug, that bug. Not really often, but I'm like, what's wrong with you people? Like, I don't get these.
I get comments all the time on my page of people... Like, I get messages constantly of people showing me these different glitches that they experience, and I'm looking at them like, what the fuck? What are you doing wrong?
Like, yeah, I'm like, this doesn't ever, even with Skyrim, yeah. Skyrim, which was probably one of the most buggiest launches for Bethesda.
Yeah.
I didn't experience a fucking bug once. Once. Yeah. Seriously.
Like, I really don't understand that aspect of the stereotype for their games. Sometimes my gun will disappear out of my hands, and all I do is let you go in third person and go back into first person, and it's back. So, yeah. I don't know. I don't see it.
Those bugs? Like, yeah, I've had that happen a couple times, especially when I was reviewing the game. But
yeah,
nothing like people are like I saw a picture of my friend NoahJ456. He posted a picture. He's like, I was going to go into the vault, but, and then it's him literally under the map falling down. I'm like,
oh,
how? Yeah.
And people getting stuck in elevators. Apparently that's like a big one. Is you can get stuck in elevators and it'll just perpetually rise.
I mean, is it because we're playing
happened
on
to me?
Is it because we're playing on PC?
It might be.
I'm on PC. Works so much better, and I think that's just always been how Bethesda games are. They work much better.
Because maybe are all of us here playing on PC, and that's that might be it. I don't know, because I really like, and I was, especially when I was reviewing the game, man, I was like looking for bugs, and like I'm like, this game's polished, like because I didn't have anything happen. But of course, people gave me shit. They're like, the fuck are you talking about, bro? This game is so broken.
Yeah, it crashed once on me.
I haven't had a crash. That's the thing.
The only issues I've had is when I had the vision glitch that set me back 7 hours, but that's my fault for not saving. And then I had the, what was that other glitch? I got stuck at a terminal once, but they actually patched that out with the newest update.
You went 7 hours without saving?
I went seven hours.
In a Bethesda game?
They added that quick save option where you literally press start, press A, and you quick save. Like, that was probably one of the best additions.
Dude, my quick save button is keybinded to the decimal point on my number pad. Wow. I constantly am just quick saving. Like,
well, because I quick save a lot, but I wasn't hard saving. And when you get this glitch, which several people got, the only way to revert it is a hard save.
Damn. I know exactly what you're talking about. I got the same thing when I...
Because it's when you exit the going into the mind mission.
Oh, huh.
Yeah,
I got like something different. When I scoped in with one of the rifles, the targeting scope.
Glitch.
Yeah, the targeting scope. I got shot really bad or something, and then when I unscoped, it was just constantly.
See, there's
bad.
A way to fix that. This glitch, only a few people had it, so it wasn't enough to fix it. But what essentially happens is you once you exit the going into the guy's mind mission. I'll stay vague.
Right.
When you exit the building, it's like you're nearsighted and everything around your field of vision is blurry.
Ooh,
and there's absolutely no fix except reloading a hard save. And since I was trying to get into the story and I got excited, I went the entire day, 7 hours without hard saving.
Jeez.
I stopped playing for a week after that. It was pretty bad.
I don't blame you, yeah. After that, though, I have to at least put like another hour in to be like, okay, you at least started it. Because if you like have like a bad thing happen in a game and you just... I don't know how to word it other than, like, you let it beat you. You're like, all right, fuck this game, man. I'm not playing it.
Yeah.
You'll never go back and get back to where
That's why I had to get back into it. I was like, look, it's Fallout 4. Like, I can be upset a little bit, but I'm not going to stay upset for long because that just defeats the purpose.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, people talk out their ass so much. They're like, oh, man, as long as there's no save deletion bugs, I don't care. And now there's no save deletion bugs, but it's like any fucking tiny dog meat took a shit. Like, oh, God.
The smallest thing.
They got rid of the stutter bug, for fuck's sake. I think that should make everybody happy.
Yeah.
Like, They actually got rid of the stutter bug. I didn't think that was possible.
See, I think it's the game's easy to appreciate if you're like a Bethesda fanboy.
Yeah,
I seriously think that's why.
Because we know their history.
Yeah,
yeah.
And I guess we can't blame other people for not, because people are coming into Fallout 4 and like, oh man, I'm so excited to get on the hype train, and they're like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah, what's happening right now?
Speaking of
that, there's a lot of stuff in Bethesda games that if you don't know what you're getting into, you are going to be really confused and a little upset.
Yeah, yeah.
I used to hate Bethesda games, so
yeah.
Heretic.
No, I meant like back with, like, actually, you know, you're gonna say heretic, because like I loved Elder Scrolls, and then like I played Fallout 3, and I'm like, this sucks dick, man. What the fuck is this? I'm like,
yeah, Mr. Quarter Million Subscribers for your Fallout content.
Yeah, here I am. Oh gosh. But speaking of that, should Fallout 4 be the last Fallout? Ask IGN, and we were breezing through the questions here just to round them up, people. Their initial reaction, they both went, oh god, fuck them. So I want to.
Should it be their last article?
These guys, when will they stop? Like, the person that wrote this article about Fallout 4 being the last Fallout, I guess he got a lot of shit from other IGN reviewers and stuff.
Really? Dude, that's fucked.
Yeah,
these,
so.
Because these colleagues, like, whenever like someone posts an article and gets shit for it, usually they like repost it and go like, I have to say, I agree with this because X, Y, and Z. And I'm to hear that, like, that's kind of undeserving in my opinion.
Yeah.
He's such a nice guy though. The guy who wrote the article, Jared.
Really? Oh, I don't know anything about him actually.
Like,
I
used to watch IGN like a lot.
Okay, Maddie.
I'm talking like 2 years ago. That's when I used to watch them. And he's a genuinely nice guy, and I always used to read his stuff. It was like him, Colin Moriarty, and like a select few others from IGN. Like, I only read and watched their stuff because the others I just either didn't like or didn't trust.
They upload 30 videos a day, so.
Yeah, and so, you know, it was really hard to sift through that shit. But, I don't know, to hear that he kind of, like, got shit kind of bothered me. But, like,
yeah,
I mean, I guess you can't expect it. You're basically attacking a fan base.
I don't know what he was thinking with that. Like,
that was it is his opinion. He also, and this sounds terrible, but he has to realize that if you put that shit online, you know how many people are going to react.
You know what you're doing to yourself when you do that. You know it's going to. It wasn't smart.
Like, I mean, props to him for having the balls to do it, but he should have realized. And that sounds terrible, but there's really no other way to put it.
Also, there's no such thing as bad publicity, though. So
yeah, true. Look at GTA. Huh?
A lot of people saw that article.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. I mean. I see, my thoughts are that there will be an end to Fallout, but, like, there's just so much places to fucking go.
Yeah.
Why you stop?
Why ever stop?
But the reason is to stop when everybody wants this. It's not a game that continues a story. Mm. That's why you stop games, because you don't want it to ruin the story.
Well, and you don't play Fallout for the story. You play Fallout for the location.
There is no story. Like, it's just every game has its own story. That's fine. But there's no continuation of the story. So, like, you have no reason to not make another one.
Yeah.
If everybody
there's, like,
wants
there's, like, a carryovers of lore and stuff, like, of, like, where people come from. They, like, make the universe feel alive and stuff. But, like, I don't think that'll ever limit them to make another sequel or whatever.
Yeah, if everyone wants it, then the fuck? Do you want money? Do you want money, Bethesda? Then make the fucking game.
Yeah, for real. Like, I don't see them ditching the series. I mean, do you think of it this way, too. It's almost a silly point to bring up because... Do you buy an IP to make two games from your studio?
Yeah, well, I mean, even Pete Hines said that. He said, we didn't buy this to make one game. Well, maybe it was Todd, but one of the head guys.
Todd, I thought Todd said that.
I don't even know. Whatever. someone said it. Someone
said it. Yeah.
You heard it first. Paladin Dance, stop being a shit. Sorry.
But yeah, like, it would make no sense for them to stop, so.
So, we all agree. They should not stop. Yeah.
And not only that, they already showed that they are totally okay with having someone else make a game for them. So
yeah,
even if they don't want to make it, they're gonna make money off of it by having someone else make it.
Yeah, and look at it at the most basic fashion. They are making fuck tons of money. Why would they stop? Mm-hmm. Like, even if they hated Fallout, I can't even imagine how much this thing. I can't imagine how much money they made on this.
They sold, I think, like $12 million.
Yeah.
Like, no, no, yeah, it's It was way more than that. It was
Just in their first week, though, I'm saying. And then probably Christmas and everything, they're probably going to be swimming in fucking dollar bills.
Right, I'm gonna Google this now. Hold up. Fallout 4 sales figures. Continue. Now, I'm just curious.
I'm curious as well. Let's hear this.
All right. Here we go. It's pulling up. Fallout 4, $750 million game launch. That was the launch weekend. Fallout 4 digital sales estimated at 1.8 million in the first 3 days. Sees 12 million copies worth. Yep, in the first week, 12. I was thinking when you said 12 million, I was thinking you meant dollars, and I was like, no. I was thinking the 750. So no, you were right. I was like 12 million dollars.
It's already at almost 14 million. That was on launch week.
Yeah.
Holy shit. I think Skyrim was like 18 million overall.
What's it called? GTA. But they didn't have
Skyrim didn't have the same level of hype that they did for Fallout 4.
I was obsessed with Skyrim.
Oh, no, I'm not saying that people were hyped, but they like turned it up specifically for Fallout 4.
Yeah. Oh, the merchandise that they sold for this game is everywhere. I just bought three more things the other day. Like, you can't look on eBay and not buy something.
I want to try the Nuka-Cola Quantum soda.
I'm so sorry. Someone is selling that on eBay. Got to pick me up a copy. Pick me up a soda. She said she was gone and she forgot.
Someone is selling a case of that on eBay. 12 of them. For $1,200.
What the fuck?
the top post on the Fallout Reddit was, I bought three cases of Quantum today. I've already made $850.
Yeah. No, like, what a, and scalp. They're restocking it.
What the fuck?
Man. Target is restocking it. Like,
okay, my girlfriend works there. I'm going to make sure she grabs me one this time. Yeah. She forgot last time.
Have her grab you a case, dude. That's cash money.
Yeah. I'll send you guys a bottle if I get a case.
Oh, I love you.
I would love to try some. Now it makes sense why I saw videos of people drinking it. They're like, oh, it's good. I'm like, okay.
I think it's just one of Jones sodas.
It's their berry soda. It's their traditional berry soda. The only difference is it has the labeling. I don't even want to drink it. I just want it to like put on my shelf.
Yeah, it's literally nothing special. It's just got the label.
Well, I mean,
on it.
To tell you the truth, though, like that's what I wanted them to do with Coke. Just like, hey, Coke. Give us a normal Coke, but put Nuka-Cola Quantum around the label. Or
Coke would ever do that.
Yeah, Pete Hines was asked about that, and he said that has been brought up at meetings. I didn't say this, but he said like it's been brought up a lot of times.
Oh,
like,
really? Oh.
Yeah, to do that. He said that on Twitter.
Wow. That's insane. I remember I asked him a couple of times about that. He's like, yeah, we brought it up more times than you can imagine. I'm like, fuck. It's worse hearing that you brought up a great idea that everyone loves and
it's
someone
not
said
here
no.
Yet. I don't have it in my hand.
I found a glitch as we're talking. The shiny part of my assault rifle is reflecting Sanctuary no matter where I am.
That's hilarious.
Anyway.
Well,
I'm so amused by
finding here. Speaking of glitches, new patch from Fallout 4. Further.
Great transition, Maddie.
Oh, God. This is not good. They apparently in the Corvega area, that big factory, they just either toned down or completely removed a lot of the shadowing over there. And it looks worse to improve frame rates, because I guess it was really bad in that area. Mm-hmm. But my question is, almost every game you play like this has a shadow option that you can turn high, low, or off completely.
You can in this one, too.
They did something fucky with the shadows because there is a mod called Shadow Boost, which, like, optimizes in-game as you go, and it keeps it from stuttering. Because what happens is, like, for me, I had an issue that I brought up in my review. I was like, when I get on top of tall buildings and shit, I get, like, a really bad frame drop. And it's because it's loading in all these shadows. And the way you fix that is by going in your settings, leaving everything the same on Ultra or what have you, but putting shadows down to, like...
They have a shadows option?
Yeah.
Yeah, they do.
There's a shadows quality or something like that.
Fuck? I was looking
and there's a
for
clear
that shit
difference,
for so long.
But I can almost guarantee that patch, if they optimize the area, they probably just cut out the shadows. Because they fucked something up with the shadows. I don't know what it is, but it just slows down the game tremendously.
Yeah, no, I have a decent graphics card. And, I mean, even on the, like, 980 Ti, you see massive frame drops when you get into high shadow areas.
Yeah, I have
like,
a 980
even
Ti.
With the Sam, top down system.
Like, I think all of us here have pretty good rigs.
Yeah,
I got a 970, so.
In that, it's like, not Diamond City, but it's like the really Boston-y area where there's, like, a ton of shit around you.
Mm-hmm.
In that area, it can get a little, Like,
yeah, no, my,
it's like,
my,
when
my
you're on the ground, you're fine. Like, it's like when you're above looking out into the world, it's like you can't, it's just something fucks up. I don't know what it is. And so now, like, people have fixed it with mods where, like, Gopher made a video and, like, he shows, like, how, like, the frame, like, dips but then boosts back up if you have the shadow boost.
Huh.
It's interesting. Weird. But, like, for me, like, it's, I don't, it's a difference, but I really, I've been playing on it for weeks now with this, like, shadow option turned off, and I haven't really noticed any difference. So if you're struggling with that frame rate and you play on PC, just turn off the shadows.
But okay, I guess
I didn't know that there was a shadow option.
Oh, sorry, go ahead.
No, I was
You have to go to the advanced settings in the.
Oh, okay. I might just not be looking at it right, but
yeah. But here's another interesting thing I actually found out the other day. Did you know that there's almost no difference between high and low textures?
What? Really?
Like, switch the textures. I was reading an article about it. If you switch up the textures, like especially close up, there is almost no difference, like at all, texture quality wise.
That's crazy. How's that possible?
Yeah, that's...
I don't know, like, I'll find the article, I'll send it to you later, but yeah, no, that's...
That is crazy.
Because I was reading a bunch of benchmark reviews, trying to figure out why I was dropping to, like, 20 frames in high areas, and one of the things they mentioned was that the texture high and low, there's almost no texture difference, therefore there's also almost no frame difference.
Yeah.
Interesting.
True story.
Wow. That is interesting.
On top of that, the patch apparently has broken modding for PC.
Always.
Like, of course. Like, disables ESPs, then you have to exit your game, turn them back on, and start it back up or some shit. I don't. Or, like, when you double-click Fallout 4 and it has that little, like, you know, it brings up the fucking Brotherhood of Steel guy and says, like, play options, whatever. That's when it disables the ESP. So from there, you have to open Nexus or what have you, turn everything on, then start the game up.
Huh.
It doesn't let you not mod your game, but in order to use your mods, you have to turn them on again.
It still lets me use my color enhancing mod though, since I'm not if you're running a mod directly through the files and not through the FNV, not FNV, whatever the typical mod deal is, it's still good. But if you're running through the mod deal, you got to restart it.
Yeah, it's really weird. I don't know. I don't know how they. Was it intentional? You think it was intentional that they just disabled?
I doubt it.
You know.
No. Nah. Well, because as much support as they have from the mod community, I can't imagine they do that on purpose.
No, I wouldn't think so either. I don't know. It took them weeks to get it out, and then it further messes up the game. Like, oh, gosh.
Little salty.
They just gradually dig themselves deeper. Like, a slow... Like, they have, like, a baby shovel right now that you could hold with two fingers, and they're slowly digging this hole right now.
I'm so surprised. Like, I'm so surprised that, that... It's that... Like, it's that big of a difference, too, with the game, after the update, that there is things that they definitely broke.
Yeah.
Because
I mean, when I started out the game, though, when I was running around, I was like, huh, it feels like things are smoother. I don't know what it was. I didn't read the patch details because nothing stood out, like, content-wise, where I was like, okay, optimization here, whatever. You know, I don't...
Yeah, that's pretty much all it was.
Yeah, like, I just read it. I was like, okay, I don't give a fuck. My game ran fine anyway, so...
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I didn't have a problem. I'm like... I guess it's just really the nitpicky.
Mm.
Yeah.
So many people nowadays, God, I can't stand
that's
it.
That's annoying.
So... All
right, so what's up next?
That would be it for our Bethesda News Roundup. So now...
That's been like the past 50 minutes, so...
Yeah.
I'd say we got a good bit in there.
Yeah, that's pretty good. How about we move on to what we're playing, what games we like to play this week, and our favorite news bit. I, like, dragged out that news because, like, I got tongued out. I was like, noodle!
Don't hurt yourself, Maddie.
Who would like to go first?
All you.
All me?
Yeah, you got it.
Okay. So... this week, I've been kind of trying to just find games to play until Christmas, because, like, every Christmas, I don't know if you guys have this, but I call it, like, my Christmas game. Like, I always have a couple of games on my list, but every Christmas I look back on, and I'm like, that's the game I played during, like, my Christmas break that, like, I really vividly enjoyed.
Yeah, that was Skyrim back when it came out for me.
Yeah, for me, last year it was Bayonetta 2. I got, like, my Wii U late and everything, and I tried it out, and I loved Bayonetta 2. So I've just been kind of trying to play different things to kind of get to Christmas Day to play, like, everything I'm really excited for. So I've been kind of, like, digging into the depths of the internet trying to find shit to play. And I found out I missed the old Hunters DLC for Bloodborne.
Huh.
Oh, bro.
Yeah, and so I'm like, oh, perfect. I'm going to fucking play this. This is a nice piece of content. It's got great reviews. Oh, my gosh. And that's not a good oh, my gosh.
Oh.
That's a bad oh, my gosh.
Rip.
Well, okay. To start the DLC, you need to kill a boss called Vicar Amelia. And for all of you Souls and Bloodborne lore nerds out there, if I pronounced any of the name wrong, I am sorry. I play the game for fun, the challenge. I platinumed it, so get on my fucking level. How about
yeah,
that?
Yeah.
And so, anyway, I pick up this DLC, and to start it up, like I said, you have to kill this certain boss. This boss is in, like, the middle of the game. So if you're like me, and you're on New Game +++, yes, beat it almost 3 times.
Plus.
Ooh, hardcore.
Yeah, so I have to make my way through this game, and mind you, New Game +++ is, like, one of the hardest fucking difficulties in the game. So I'm basically replaying Bloodborne at this point.
Right.
Grind my way through this boss. Kill it on my first try, fortunately. Blessed. Thank you so much. And I'm like, all right, cool. Let's play the DLC. Get in there. And it's really cool. It's like Yharnam, old Yharnam, but like remade. And it's like a whole different reality. It's interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, it's called The Hunter's Nightmare, because the place you return to level up and shit, it's called The Hunter's Dream. So I think there's a bit of like irony there and stuff.
Oh yeah, no, I get that. That's
yeah,
cool.
And there's a bunch. I mean, it's typical From Software. Like, it's really good. It's really tough. But the reason I say like the oh my god bad thing is because it's so annoying that you have to get to the middle of the game to start this DLC. And
oh,
the reason,
I hate it. Shit,
what
I hate
I'm
it
saying the reason I hate this is because now that I'm on New Game +++, it's fucking tough as nails. Like, things two-shot me, which you could argue is typical Bloodborne, because
right.
It's so agile, you don't want to get hit, you shouldn't be
yeah,
getting
yeah.
hit. But for me personally,
and
oh my gosh, like, I'm fighting this boss and it's just so ungodly tough, not because of the attacks, but because I barely do damage. I'm level 161.
Oh my god.
Damn, bro.
Like, you think Jesus. With a fully maxed fucking weapon, Ludwig's Holy Blade, which turns into a giant two-handed fucking buster sword,
yeah,
that I could fucking take this thing out. And I summon help, but the boss is so tough it kills the summon help, so I'm like, oh, fuck.
Oh my god.
Yeah, but it's, like I said, it's typical From Software. It's,
yeah,
don't get me wrong,
it's
for anyone
hard
out
shit.
There. Yeah, don't get me wrong for anyone out there. It's fun, but right now I just don't have that, like, urge to push through and finish.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't have that same grind, and I don't want to waste that grind, because for me, it's like, to play a From Software game is like a ritual. You got to get ready for it. It's like, okay.
Yeah,
yeah, that's
it. Exactly. You don't want to play it just to get through it. You want to
yeah.
enjoy.
And
you play it for
and
the
so,
experience.
Yeah,
that's
and so like, I'm deciding, do I just want to say, fuck it, I wasted my $20 and just wait and save my energy for Dark Souls 3? That's what I'm thinking about doing.
Yeah.
But this fucking... And, like, so many people are... I wish I read so many articles beforehand, because, like, people are like, here's why you shouldn't buy the Blood Hunters Old Hunters DLC if you have beat Bloodborne. And I clicked on it last night, and I read it, and I'm like, this guy had the same issue I had. He's like, yeah, well, except I was like, I beat the game twice.
Right.
So he's like, I beat the game, and I concluded my journey there. I found out when I spent my $20 that I had to go through half, like, not really half the game, but, like, a good portion of the game. If you know your way around. If you don't know your way around, then you would probably spend even more time in the main game before you even touch DLC.
Yeah.
That's a pain in the ass.
Ugh. But yeah, so if you're like, if you killed Vicar Amelia and you fucking have $20 to spare and you're not on New Game +++, yeah, you might want to buy the DLC. But yeah, other than that...
That's sort of upsetting, actually, that it's that difficult on a...
I mean, difficulty is the name of the game for these type
yeah,
of games, obviously.
That's the point, but...
But there comes a line where there's difficulty, and then there's just...
There's just,
like,
I wasted my $20.
Yeah,
exactly.
There is that line.
Yeah, and it was more so the start, and then when I found out that they don't scale properly at my level, where everything is just fucking... Oh my gosh.
Yeah, yeah.
I get fucking destroyed all the time. These assholes with fucking Egg Magdala whips or whatever they're called. Motherfucker kills me in 2 hits. I'm like, what the fuck? Like, I can't stand
it. Yeah, and you're obviously not bad at the game if you beat it, like, twice.
Yeah,
so,
like I mean, I had to get back into the groove, but that's the only thing that I took, like, I was like, okay, yeah, I don't want to play through, like, a quarter of the game again, but I had to get used to things. I had to kill, like, 2 bosses to get there. So I was like, all right, you know, I'm into the groove now. I'm used to Bloodborne again. So it kind of worked in my advantage. But, like, even yeah. then, like, oh, gosh, so tough. Anyway, as for more salty news, onto my favorite news bit, because I just want to talk about it a little bit. There's a lot of beef about this Final Fantasy VII remake. Only Square Enix would fuck up a remake of the Most Wanted game. Like,
Konami would fuck it up pretty bad.
True. Right. Dude,
they don't count.
Yeah, they don't. They don't count. They don't exist in anyone's eyes.
We don't speak of them.
So I don't know if you guys read or if you're paying attention to this. I know not a lot of people.
I didn't hear this.
Well, I know a lot of listeners out there aren't like big on JRPGs, but I think a lot of people have played Final Fantasy VII because it's such like a traditional.
I sure hope so.
Yeah, it's like one of the best. Like, it's aged phenomenally. If you guys are wondering, it's only like $15 on the PS4. If you want to play it, you can get it on PC as well. I played it. It's like it's as long as you want to make it, really, because there's so much to do. It's one of the best games ever, in my opinion.
Yeah, it really is.
I know a lot of people argue that's overrated, but if you go in with like curious expectations, but not like this is going to be the best thing ever, you'll really enjoy yourself. Anyway,
exactly.
Now they're deciding this will be a multi-part series. Now, a lot of people are saying this is episodic, and Square really hasn't given a straight answer on it. And the issue I have with this is because a lot of people are freaking out thinking that it's going to be like a Telltale series. But I don't see them doing that. And the only reason I don't is because I don't think it's physically possible to do a JRPG in an episodic fashion.
No.
No, that makes no sense.
It's impossible.
The game looks fucking phenomenal, by the way. I was watching the little bit of gameplay they've shown. Absolutely phenomenal.
Yeah, it looks fucking great. And I feel like what they're doing is, because there's been so many like branches for Final Fantasy VII. There was Crisis Core on the PSP, which was also fucking amazing. They obviously had the original Final Fantasy VII. They had Advent Children, and I think there was like one more. And I know Advent Children was a movie, but my guess is if they're doing this multi-part thing, I'm guessing that maybe, fingers crossed, they're gonna like remaster all of Final Fantasy VII, then like all of Crisis Core. But then I got thinking about it a little bit more. I was just like, fuck, Final Fantasy VII is such a big game to remaster everything. And make it look how it does now. I can't imagine it. So like,
no,
I don't know what to expect. I don't know what to do.
It's I have mixed feelings on the matter. I do think that, and this is if they're doing the episodic method so they can get the game out sooner, like, oh, it's going to be another 2 years if we do it all together, perfectly happy with it. But if they're just doing it episodic so they can make more money, fuck off.
I think it's to get the game out sooner, at least.
Which, if that's the case, I'm totally for it.
Let's say it's like, I'm trying to think, like, the episodic fashion, but it's like each episode carries your save files, and it's about like 30 to 40 hours of content.
Yeah.
And it's at like $20 a pop. See, $20 though, you're going to spend like 100 something bucks on this. Like, I don't get it. Like, there's no way of doing this without either overpricing it, cutting it short, fucking something up. You know what I'm saying?
I'm scared. Yeah. I'm scared.
Unless it's sort of like how Resident Evil. I don't know if they're a good example. Yeah, they released their episodes. You can either buy them separately or you can buy them all with one pack. Maybe they might just have like an all the episodes for like $60 or something like that, like the price of a normal game would be.
I agree, but then like I don't know why they would just, if people are gonna, like with most people with I think Telltale games, some people like the wait, some people don't, and just wait until it's season pass and then buy it and play the whole thing.
Yeah,
that's how I do it.
Yeah, same. So I wonder if like they already have those statistics on hand to see like who does what with these other episodic franchises, and you see that most people are gonna wait anyway.
Yeah.
Then why not just make the complete product, sell it?
Yeah.
Because if people are gonna wait and you're not gonna get your money right away, then you're gonna have less to spend on resources when you're developing new episodes.
Yeah.
And they're just gonna get fucking worse.
I cry every time.
Yeah, I'm nervous, is what I'm trying to say.
I'm nervous as fuck.
It's very slippery. Very slippery slope that they're in.
As long as, you know what? As long as they don't, you know what? Actually, no. They have so many games that, like, I have to say, as long as they don't fuck it up. As long as they don't fuck up Kingdom Hearts 3, because that's my childhood.
Yep. As long as if they fuck up Kingdom Hearts 3, I'm done. I'm just done.
Yeah, I'm going to fucking
beat. I will not forgive.
Me beating the shit out of someone. It's called, Kingdom Hearts 3 sucks. Just going to be me slugging it out with some random dude I find in like Walmart or some shit. Someone photoshopped me fighting someone in Walmart.
I'd watch it.
Fuck
it.
God.
You know, they can't fuck up Final Fantasy 15. That game went from like, oh man, it's a dead project, to like
0 to 100, nigga, real quick.
Yeah, it looks amazing now. You can't fuck up Final Fantasy 7 Remake now. Like, oh my gosh.
They're walking on a slippery slope, because if they fuck up a single one of these, it is going to be their head.
There's a lot riding on them, really. Those are massive, like, two massive franchises. Two massive franchises, Final Fantasy and Kingdom Hearts.
Yeah.
And that they're coming out, so, like, they're both coming out pretty close to each other.
I almost feel bad for them.
Yeah, that's...
Oh, gosh. You know, it's like, you can't pick and choose, like, oh, they can fuck this up, but they at least they won't fuck this up, but, like, there's just so many good franchises that they can't fuck up.
You got me scared now, goddammit.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to be them, to be honest.
They're in a good opportunity where it's like, okay, let's take our time and do this right.
This can either go really well or really poorly.
Oh, yeah. Mm. Oh, gosh. It would crush my heart if they just ruined everything I grew up with. Let's move on to something happier. You guys...
Something less depressing.
Yeah,
you guys all right. You next. I'll go last.
Okay. Well, I've been playing Fallout 4, obviously. I mean...
Clearly.
Who hasn't been playing Fallout 4? I haven't got really into settlements yet. Like, because Preston wants me to save every single settlement in the planet, because there's ghouls across the map that are attacking them. But
somehow he knows.
Yeah, like I haven't really built much. I have a wall around Sanctuary, but it doesn't do anything because apparently raiders only attack from one end.
Yeah, they only attack from one side.
Yeah. So what was the point of me building a wall? But yeah, I've just been playing Fallout 4. I've got so
I can't wait till they add a mod in new raider mechanics.
Yeah, I want... There is something...
Because I spent a shit ton of resources, like, tricking out my defense system, and I'm like, oh, could have put a bunch of turrets on one wall and
exactly.
Been fine.
Exactly. They attack, like, two raiders at a time, and they have, like...
It was clearly a vestigial system they added to appeal to the Minecraft craft survival crowd.
I don't think the crafting is well done at all.
The weapon crafting is fucking phenomenal.
Oh, yeah, that's great. But, like, the settlement thing seems like it was kind of... It was a second. Plan. Yeah, it seems like they just kind of threw it in there.
You can tell by the tutorial. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. What tutorial?
Yeah.
they're a fucking pathetic attempt at one, if I'm honest.
Yeah, and I really didn't like it at all. And something that I hate. Obviously, everyone hates like gaps in their fences and stuff.
Yes.
Why can't
everything connect?
And I hate it. I have
fucking 10-foot gaps because the floor won't let me build. Yeah.
You know how, like, you could be walking through Bethesda, and, like, stuff clips through the wall all the time. Why can't you clip the fence through the wall to get rid of a gap?
Yeah.
Or through the floor a little bit to get rid of a gap.
Yeah, the terrain, the way they set up the terrain. It's just,
I can't do anything with it. That's
the beauty of the mod called Simple Intersection, and I highlighted it in my modding series. It's literally that. It lets you clip into the wall to, like... build things. It doesn't, you don't have to lock shit in.
I haven't downloaded that yet.
It's literally...
I need this.
You need it.
I need that in my life right now.
Yeah, if you're going to do anything related to settlement building at all. And if you download that with the settlement supplies expanded, which puts, like, every asset in the game for you to place... Like,
oh, yeah, because...
You can put, like, rocks, trees, fucking giant platforms. It's amazing.
For real? Oh, yep, I'm doing this.
No, that's so cool. Because I was looking through I was just trying to build a basic, like, house. And I'm looking through all the assets that they give you to use, and it's like... nothing.
Once you build the security and the basics, there's not really anything
that's,
to put
that's
in
about it.
Yeah. Yeah, like you can put it, oh, I can put in some chairs, fuck yeah.
Yeah, oh, okay. Yeah,
I wish they had more special settlement items, you know, like they only have like a very slight few, like the artillery, Mama Murphy's chair and like everything else pertains to the main story, which we won't spoil.
Let me just say, the artillery, I am a terrible person. I will go to settlements that I haven't taken care of. Almost every single person is dead. And the only two surviving people, I put one in artillery and I put one on like resource runs. And I don't care if I don't give them defenses. I don't give them food. I need somebody on artillery. Yeah. That's all I give a shit about.
How much I haven't done much with settlements. I've only built at Sanctuary. All the other settlements
I've done Sanctuary and the castle. That's it.
See, but yeah. The thing that I don't think we can front is that settlement, when you start diving in, is addicting. Anytime I start building, I don't know if you guys agree, actually.
Yeah, no, I spend fucking hours.
Yeah, when I built my Trump wall, it was fun. But, like, just the rest of it, I don't know. I have a farm, so I can have adhesive. That's about it, though. Mm.
I don't know. It's I like it, but, yeah, the mods
once again. Also, you can scrap Sean's crib.
What?
What?
It's so fucked up. You can.
I could do
it
that.
Gives you like two pieces of wood, and you can scrap two his crib. Of wood.
That's like selling your wedding ring.
Yeah, that's so messed up.
I think what's funny is I think I did sell my wedding ring to get Overseer's Guardian.
Oh my
God. I was like wheeling and dealing. I'm like, oh, I need like 80 caps right now. I was like, oh, I take the
shit.
Take the wedding ring. I'll like, right, Piper anyway.
I can't remember what
you
this
need to
was
go back and murder the guy and take your thing back.
I was like, yeah, I like Piper anyway. Fuck it. Yeah, why not?
I'd fuck Piper.
Oh, yeah. How about that gaming news, though?
Yeah. My favorite news was obviously Bethesda expanding.
Absolutely.
Much better than that.
I mean, I can't blame you because it's just, like we said, no one predicted that.
When you sent me that on Twitter, because I hadn't seen it till you sent me that, I was just staring at my phone like, what does this say? I'm reading that?
Yeah, I woke up and like I follow a couple of viewers and like they'll just message me anytime like something pops up and like I woke up and like it was like so-and-so sent you a photo, so-and-so sent me a photo, so-and-so sent you a photo. I was like, what the fuck happened? And like, people sent me a bunch of memes and like swipe over and literally each one of them is like, we're excited to introduce our Montreal studio. I'm like, oh, it's just a publishing arm. And like I click on it and it says like Montreal for Bethesda Game Studios. I'm like,
Game Studios.
What? Yeah.
Oh my God.
Fucking shit your pants.
Yeah, I was just laying there. I literally said out loud to myself, I'm like, fuck, like, I couldn't believe it.
It's so crazy.
It's the beauty of waking up with a closed door and just being by myself in my bed. I literally just verbally, what the fuck?
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
Yeah, I do that whether or not the door is open, to be fair. It's like, is everything all right in there? No.
Not at all.
That's expanded. Oh
my God. They're like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Oh, yeah, I posted that to my page, too, and I was like, does this mean more Fallout? And someone was like, no, it just means... Fucking,
and then you just like ban them.
They were just being bullshit. Like, and it was, it just like, really points out.
I don't see Bethesda literally going Fallout 4, Fallout 5. I don't see that. No way.
How great would it be, though? Like, totally unfair to Elder Scrolls fans, but how great would that be?
Part of me doesn't want them to do that, though. Like, I don't want them to fucking, like.
I do. I want them. I don't want them to do that. I want them to give Obsidian, let Obsidian do their thing. Because
I want to. Obsidian I want it, them. To make a Skyrim, a new Elder Scrolls, so the improvements they make in that will come into the next Fallout, so it doesn't feel like the same thing.
Well, what they should do is just let Obsidian do Fallout, because like they did last time, where Fallout 3...
I don't want Obsidian to permanently have the franchise, but I would love to see another Obsidian game.
Though. Yeah.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Fallout New Orleans would be so fucking awesome.
Yeah, that cycle is really good, because we waited a long time for Fallout 4, and then... like to give them the ability to do it, and then you give them the engine and you give them the assets and everything, they're going to make it again like they did last time in like 2 years. So like,
I mean, if I'm Bethesda, give them time to make it. If you give them time, I mean, you look what
don't put them in the
impressive ass game for a game that took like a year and 8 months. Like, holy shit.
Even though it was the same engine, it was amazing what they did with it. Just, I'd be pissed if Bethesda put the clamps on them again with a fucking bonus, because that wrecked so much.
Yeah.
I mean, that probably got rid of any chance of us having a new game from them, to be honest.
And
we'll
please,
be lucky if we see another.
The whole ending thing with, like, you can't continue the game after the ending.
Yeah, they really
that. Let's be real.
They really fucked that one up.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's my gaming news.
Your turn, John.
All right. I guess I'll go then. I say as I take my Hot Pocket out of the oven. So the game I've been playing is EVE Online. Not EVE Online, what am I saying? Elite Dangerous.
Wait, where the fuck did that one come from, though?
I get
back
EVE
a little
and Elite
bit.
Mixed up. They're similar. I've been playing a lot of Elite Dangerous because I got this cool new mod where basically I'd already told them about it, but it's called HCS Voice Pack, and you download a program that lets you like talk to the computer, and it recognizes your voices and does key presses. And then the voice pack adds an AI to your computer. It has over 1,500 recognized commands, and you say things, and it responds to you and does it in the game. So you can sit there like you're in Star Trek and like talk to your ship, and it'll talk back and tell it what to do. It's cool. And then I've been playing a lot of Rainbow Six Siege because it's just a really good game.
Oh yeah,
fuck! Love Siege. I want to play Rainbow Six Siege.
And then my gaming news, most people know, but Witcher 3 winning Game of the Year, which I think it deserved. I won't lie.
Yeah, I mean, everyone thought, like, I was like flipping the fuck out because The Witcher 3
Oh, I won. Saw that. I saw that.
I'm like, I think it deserves it. It's obviously the better game. I just enjoyed Fallout. I don't fucking pick my game of the year off of, oh, well, every press ass out there fucking gave this game a 10 and everyone likes it. I'm going to pick that as my game of the year. Like, fuck no. I'm going to pick what I enjoyed. I enjoyed Fallout 4 a lot. Yeah.
I'm not saying Witcher 3 didn't deserve it. They most certainly did.
I am glad that Metal Gear Solid 5 didn't win it, because I'm going to be honest, it's a fun game, but it just had too much wrong with it. And I mean, like, that's not Hideo Kojima's fault by any means. I feel so bad for the poor guy.
It's really none of the team's fault. I think it's
Konami. It was all Konami. Fuck Konami. Yeah. Hashtag fuck Konami.
I mean,
how bad can they really, like, what are they doing? Can they really?
They are literally canning all console development and just doing mobile.
Yeah, but can that mobile everybody hates that?
Yeah, I was about to say, and the pachinko or whatever the fuck it's called.
Yeah, like, I don't really understand what their business plan is, though.
It's because, because I watch Alpha Omega Sin a lot, and he said that the guy who basically runs Konami openly admitted he knows nothing about video games and only
his son or something, and he's been firing people left and right. He's been doing a bunch of shit. He doesn't know what he's doing. He is entirely in it for the money. That's why they're doing a ton of mobile and pachinko and canning all of their other development. And why they wouldn't let Hideo Kojima attend his fucking award.
Yeah, probably the only good thing I've seen from Kotaku in like the last 10 years.
I almost was threw
when
up.
They tweeted, imagine thinking, let's ban our legendary game developer from a popular game show as a good
idea.
I'm
so happy they got booed. I am so happy that the whole audience booed. Because that is just, of all of the disgusting things I've seen in gaming recently, that took the cake. Like, I almost felt sick when I read that.
Like, I don't understand how they expect to continue as a company, though. Like, who's going to buy their stuff?
they don't have any stuff.
They don't, I don't get it, though. It's like, what does that accomplish? If you at least pretend things are okay and let Hideo Kojima go off on his own, pursue his own things, instead you say, fuck you.
That's what they've been doing for the past year. They took his name off the box art. They cut out a ton of his stuff.
Their press release, fired him. They literally said that Hideo Kojima is on vacation. That was their words, that he's on vacation.
Bullshit.
Like, I can't wait until the end of the year, because that's
so fucking stupid. Yeah, I love
that's it. That's when his contract's up, is at the end of the year.
He almost ruined his marriage working on their games. Like, he's probably taken 20 years off of his life from stress, because he would work day and night on their games. And then new management just says, no, fuck you, we don't like you.
He is literally going to drop the biggest bomb on January 1st. Like, it's...
Yeah.
Like, I can't wait.
I can already promise you, within some point in January or February, there will be a expose. The truth about Konami from Hideo Kojima.
I can't wait till his NDAs expire and he can just slam them.
Oh, it's going
to
be great.
You know that's what they're scared of. That's why they haven't fired him yet. They're trying to figure out, they're trying to delay, like, make time while they can figure out how they're going to keep him from ruining them even more than they've ruined themselves.
Yep. In the process, they're ruining themselves, though.
Like, absolutely. The truth, though, like, if I'm Kojima, I just want to go out and do a Kickstarter project. Everyone would want that.
Silent Hills, though, every time I think about it.
Oh, my God. The guy that plays Daryl, I can't remember his name. Like, he was the face.
Norman Reedus. Yeah,
he was so, like,
bummed.
Upset about that. Yeah, like,
they had Jito Ito on that game.
Yeah.
He's like the Japanese horror legend. The amount of potential that game had, it really hurts me every time I think about what we lost.
Exactly.
Like, I know that sounds melodramatic, but dear God.
I'm not sure if this is true or not, but apparently Microsoft wanted to buy it from
Kojima. I heard that was fake.
You know
what?
It was a rumor that made sense that I think.
Yeah, that would make so much sense.
When Konami goes belly up, though, I give them 2 years tops. When they go belly up, they'll sell off their IPs. They'll have to, like all these other, like THQ and stuff, like they've done.
Yeah.
And when they go belly up and sell it off, oh God, I hope Microsoft picks it up.
Go time. Bring back the TMNT fucking beat 'em up games, man.
Yes. I have those on my Game Boy Advance. I still play them.
Oh,
yeah, I'd be totally fine with Microsoft making. I would buy an Xbox One to fucking play that. Like,
I would buy any console to play that Silent Hills. PT is the most terrifying game I've ever played, and it was walking
literally down.
Yeah.
They nailed.
That game scared the fuck out of me, man.
That would have sold. Their business model is all about money. That would have made so much money.
Yeah, that part where you're fucking answering the phone and like there's a message playing and you look to your left and the fucking thing just jumps at you. I'm like, oh god, that game.
I can't handle that game. I couldn't handle it.
Fetus in the fucking sink. Like who the
fuck? Yeah. Like, that game is so big that
have you read any of Jito Ito's stuff? No. I'm probably butchering his name. He's a god. Like his stuff is absolutely fucking terrifying. He's made Uzumaki, which is about spirals. He made another one about fish with legs, and you can see his influence on the game. All the fucked up shit in there. That's his forte, and combine that with Hideo Kojima and Guillermo del Toro.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I can't even imagine.
It would have been genius. It really would have been.
Oh, it hurts.
You can only
it
hope that one day.
One day.
I'll admit though, wouldn't have had the balls to play it.
Dude, I would have watched
ages to nut up and play PT.
Even so though, like,
and I had to have a room of four people with me.
Like when we think about it, the names involved in this game, once Kojima's gone from Konami, they could get together and make a game like this, just not named Silent Hills, obviously. But like, they could make a game.
They could. I mean, I know they've even Guillermo del Toro has like talked about it, like potentially doing that. They could totally do it. It would be hard to do on the same levels if you have a giant company like the company Cohesion.
They can get a company.
I'm telling you, dude, Kickstarter.
Hideo
Kojima's next project will be Kickstarter.
Any publisher in the world would publish a game from Hideo Kojima.
Yeah.
Yes.
Anyone.
Oh,
so
shit. When you're done, that totally made me remember. When you're done, I'll say it.
Go ahead. Good.
Oh, I was gonna say, Psychonauts 2. I just remember that. That's what I can remember.
Playing that when I was
Psychonauts. Yeah, they just for like it's been like 12 years or something. They finally kickstarted Psychonauts 2. I'm so happy. Like I've been wanting that game.
I didn't even know there was like a large demand for it, but like I remember like because like everyone was like, oh my god, Psychonauts 2. I'm like, what the fuck is a Psychonauts? And like I looked up gameplay of it, and I'm like, I do remember playing this vaguely.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm hype.
So now you got it too.
Although
like,
they are
everyone's clamoring. Everyone clamors for like not the dumbest games, but like, why aren't people asking for a new Star Wars RPG?
Yeah.
Like. Fuck, man. Like, ask for... Where's Sly Cooper on the PS4? Ask for shit that actually matters.
Yeah.
Psychonauts, a 2005 platformer. Fuck you. No. Like, I get it. I get that everyone has their own little niches and shit they like, but how about something that actually changed gaming, you know? Fuck.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna get so much shit for that, but honestly...
New Rogue Squadron.
A new Star Wars RPG.
Can you imagine a new Rogue Squadron with like modern graphics?
Yeah, like that. That would be cool.
Oh.
How about continuing Republic Commando? How about reviving 1313?
I want a rated M Star Wars game. I want a mature Star Wars game.
That's
please.
What 1313 was gonna be.
1313, I cry every time. It's not as bad. That's like second.
I got good news for you. I don't know how this wasn't your favorite news. Now that I think about it, dude, they're gonna probably. They said that they might revive the project.
No way! Who said that?
Lucasfilms. They said
I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go jerk off or something. I'll be right back.
They're looking at old games and shit, like all of them, and deciding like what people want, and like they don't want to let gold just sit there. Apparently.
Yeah, it is gold.
And so I'm like,
Konami, they want
KOTOR. Come on, fucking do it. Bring it back.
Dude, BioWare making a new KOTOR. Look, first I would want a 1313 or Commando, but then I would totally do KOTOR 3.
I would do. Dirty things for a new Star Wars.
I would do. Although I'm kind of scared that they would like modernize it to the point of fucking it up.
Dude, just
Maddie,
like
got,
they
Maddie,
quote unquote streamline it because KOTOR, you know, half the feel of KOTOR was its deep, deep RPG system. And I mean, you look at games like Fallout 4 where they shred out a lot of the RPG system to make it more of a mass appeal sort of thing. And I'm worried they'd try to mass appeal.
See,
and
I think if they literally took like the template for what's it called? What's the game? Dragon Age Inquisition. Like that. Lots of big open spaces. You take that instead of making it like areas around Thedas or whatever. Instead, make it planets. Like now you're on Coruscant. Now you're on this or that.
Yeah.
Take that. Fill it up with all the side quests, all the collectibles. Have this large fucking group of interesting characters for different playthroughs. Have multiple options for different playthroughs. Fucking boom. Sell it. Oh, gosh.
Money, 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 money. All I want is money. No, I honestly, that would work well. I'm just, the thing is, who would be the publisher?
Yay.
No, fuck. God, no. No, don't even joke about it. Seriously.
They would have to be. They would have to be. They own the fucking license. They'd have to.
Oh, no. Star Wars EA will fuck it.
Yeah, I got Battle Flop. I got awful ass Battle Flop.
Modern War Battles 5.
Dude, I love it, though. It is literally, that game is, to my surprise, failing completely. Like, I thought people would buy it anyways. It'd be like another Destiny where it sucked but people play. But it's already on sale for $40. Like, suck a dick.
Really?
I told my friend. My friend actually won this. I told him that it was going to sell no matter what because it's Star Wars. Mm-hmm. Clearly not, though.
they
but it looks like a movie. I mean,
good for them. You know? How about the game itself?
Looks like a movie.
Dude, beautiful. I love it, though. I'm like, I'm opening the flyers for like Christmas and stuff, and I see like holiday sale, Star Wars Battlefront $40. I'm like, that's 40. A fucking
Battlefront. Oh my god, so much potential wasted. Much potential wasted because they had to meet a fucking deadline.
Yeah. I don't want to blame developers.
No, DICE did their shit, but they spent so much time making it look pretty that they didn't have any time to put all of the customization and all of everything else in.
But like, I don't care that people don't want to blame the developers. You have a fucking roadmap hand drawn by Rebellion from previous Battlefront games.
Rebellion was good. I liked Rebellion.
This is how you do Battlefront. People like this. So even if you made a carbon copy, which I get isn't appealing as a game developer, I can see that from interviews I've read and stuff that they don't want to do that. You still have a roadmap on what people like, what people don't like. Follow that. What the fuck is so hard about that?
They just ran out of time. They were so busy trying to make it look good with their new technology, which you have to admit, it's the best looking game ever.
Yeah, easily.
Hands down, I don't think I'll ever play a game that good looking in the next 3 years.
Yeah,
but it has nothing inside it. They spent so much time on that, and then they hit the deadline.
It's a pretty box, and you open it, and you're like, oh, it's got a.
There's nothing inside. There's no substance to it. Unless you want to, pay $50 for the DLC that they had half the team working on instead of working on the actual game, because EA wants their $50 DLC. Goddamn.
What bothers me even more is the Battle of Jakku DLC fucking sucks.
I actually enjoy it. I wish they added more, but all.
Oh god,
the map's good. Awful. I like the map. I will stand by that.
I don't like it at all. I tried playing it for like an hour and I was like, this is just shitty. I'll wait until they release the inevitable fucking 4 packs of DLC, wait for that to go on discount. I'll fucking come back to this game later, though. I'm not going to waste my time playing
it. If there's anybody playing it, though, that's the downside. When you have a game with almost no content. The launch week, there was only 49,000 people playing it at peak.
That's so ridiculous. Oh, my God.
49,000 people on PC at peak time on launch
weekend. And it's a multiplayer game, too. That's...
That's what happens when you make a multiplayer-only game. You cut out the single player, and then you don't add anything substantial. You just slack. Like, if you're going to cut out the single player, add something substantial.
Yeah.
Hold on. I have in my group chat somewhere... Hold on. Let me find it. You guys can keep talking, because I literally have, like... Because my friend was talking about looking into buying Battlefront, and he's like, it looks like the player base is already dying because... Oh, let me find it.
Yeah.
No, it's... There's a website that shows you, like, people playing the game. And that makes me sad, because it's Battlefront, guys. Like, we all grew up on Battlefront. Battlefront was my first game ever. It's the reason I got a PS2. I've said that on here before. The fact that I'm not going to be able to play it 6 months from now, it breaks my heart. There's so much. I mean, we've had a ton of good stuff come out in gaming recently, but we've also had so many heartbreakers too. Like,
It's very upsetting. It's
a big heartbreak.
There's so much upsetting stuff in gaming recently.
Hold on, let me go on. Like, so I don't know why I'm using my phone. I'm sitting here on my computer. I do that all the time. Have you guys ever had Twitter open and like you have it open on your PC and then you go on
to your phone
on Twitter and you're like, why?
Every single time.
Every single time. Yep.
All the time. Let's see here.
Every time, all the time.
Oh, I want to buy. Let's see how much is in my PayPal. Pick up your phone. Like, what? It says right there on the top of my screen. Log into PayPal.
Yeah, so how about that new TMNT fucking trailer?
Wait, what?
I didn't.
SWBstats.com. Hold on. Battlefront stats. Current online players, 9,600 on PC.
9,000?
The peak within the last 24 hours is 16.
Dude. Halo Reach has at least 15,000 players on it anytime on the 360.
On the 360.
Xbox One is at 480,792.
Wait, how many?
Wait, what?
Or four? Did I say 400? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
48,792. Oh, okay.
Yeah, consoles are doing much better.
Well, that's expected.
And then PS4 is 76,000.
Yeah. That's expected, though.
But that's still...
That's still not a lot at all.
No, that's still pretty sad.
You put it into perspective, they want to sell 13 million units, I think they said.
Yeah, that's why their stocks dropped through the floor.
That's their goal.
Yeah, they could want to do anything they want.
That's not a high goal for these days.
Yeah, like these days, they Fallout 4 sold that much, combining with the digital and physical in a weekend.
Yeah, for games these days, especially AAA titles, Star Wars Battlefront on the name, 13 million? That's
pretty conservative. Yeah, but that's actually way too much, all things considered.
That's like barely over 100,000 players, and that's only 2 weeks later.
Yeah.
That is sad.
Right?
Crazy.
Anyway, let's move on to the viewer questions. Right, we forgot about that. I always forget. I genuinely forget because I fucking, we get caught up in these conversations and I'm looking at my phone sometimes. Okay. The first question comes from Unlimited Power, and we kind of talked about this a little bit. When do you think Bethesda's next game will arrive?
2018.
Spring 2018. Summer
2017. 2017 is a stretch. 2018 is it definitely.
Fall 2017. Yeah. I'm saying it now. Fall 2017.
God damn it,
Fall 2017.
Fall 2017. I'm going to fucking make a push.
So you're thinking Elder Scrolls 6.
Will come out in 2
That's
years.
Assuming they've already started, though. All
right, well, actually, you know what? Maybe. Okay, hold on. We're at the end of 2015 now. They got a full year, and then they got another full year. Yeah, you know what? Fuck it. Yeah, what do I have to lose? End of 2017.
All right, well, I've said more ridiculous. This podcast. And,
I don't even know what the fuck he said.
I don't know. But, yeah. 2018 at the latest, but 2017 is definitely possible.
I'm going with fall 2017.
Especially with this new...
That's what I'm saying. With this new studio, I'm changing the game. They're not predictable anymore.
No, they're not.
No. Well, and I mean, it depends on it. Have they already started work on it? Which I would have to say, at the very least, pre-production, because that's kind of how it works.
They're doing something with it.
They have definitely started, probably, I'm going to go with, in 2013.
Yeah.
2013, 2012, when DLC stopped and they started full production on Fallout 4, pre-production for Elder Scrolls 6 started, and they... fully produced Fallout 4.
That seems to be what they do. It seems to be that they probably at least.
And now with that new expansion, that pre-production is really ramped up. Yeah, fuck yeah. Yeah. Fall 2017. Let's get it.
Fall 2017.
Oh gosh, I'm excited over nothing. Dude, nothing is happening and I'm excited.
I've never even thought it's never even crossed my mind that Bethesda would release a game within a 2 year period.
I know, right?
Like, that never crossed my mind.
I don't think that will either, really, but I'm gonna be fucking. What are you doing? Are you like beating the shit out of something?
I'm making a hot pocket. Give me a second. Keep doing your thing.
You literally just made another hot pocket.
I'm
hungry.
Apparently.
I'm a growing man. Let me have my food.
Something like that.
Calories.
Alright, I'm done. I'm coming back. Please cut that.
That'll
be leaving shitty parts.
That's gold.
Yeah.
Always have that one moment in the podcast that people will message me 4 months later. Hey, I remember when this happened, like when you left me alone or whatever. Like, there's always that one
moment. Great when I left you and Mallory by yourselves.
And then Mallory left me by myself.
I actually remember that.
Yeah, I remember that specifically because
Mallory ditched me and I was like, are you fucking serious?
I totally lied because I had to go to the bathroom so bad. I was dying in my chair. I'll never forget that. Never forget. So, next question comes from Cabin Sand. Make a team. One Marvel character, one DC character, and one video game character. And then he asks after whose team would probably win. So we'll all create our own teams now. All right.
And I got two. I don't know for DC.
Damn.
Not a clue.
For me, Marvel's going to be Spider-Man. I'm going to take Spider-Man.
He's Iron Man.
My Marvel representative. Okay.
I'm all Iron Man. There's
I'd have to say what for Marvel?
Yeah.
Deadpool.
Okay, so we have Spider-Man, Deadpool, and Iron Man.
Okay.
Then DC.
Now for DC.
this was
I don't like DC, so
exactly.
Fuck you.
I'm not a fan of DC, so like
DC's too confusing. If you've read Infinite Crisis, oh my god, the headache.
I'm trying to think of like Injustice and like.
I'm trying to not pick Superman. That's what I'm trying to. I'm trying to not go.
Yeah, with I'm gonna go with like because I really was good with her in Injustice. I'm gonna go with Wonder Woman. I like Wonder Woman. Mm. She's cool.
I'd have to go with what's his name? Oh fuck! Give me a second.
Fuck! This is probably gonna be difficult.
I haven't read DC in a while. I'll go with Lobo. Not from Infamous. Infamous. I already liked him, but I'm a hipster. But no, I have to say Lobo.
All right, so Lobo, okay. Wonder Woman,
the Joker.
All right, yeah, fair enough. As you can all tell, I'm sure there's got to be some comic fan out there just cringing at our superhero choice.
I'm so sorry.
We sicken him right now because we're just picking the most stereotypical heroes.
Yeah, the Joker.
And it's funny because I actually used to read DC comics all the time, but it's been years. Like, I've read all of them at my library, and I just haven't checked out any new ones.
Comics are so intimidating because there is so much ground to cover that I don't want to do.
Exactly. I listen to things.
And then one video game character I think we can all come up with good ones here.
I got one. Joel from The Last of Us.
I was thinking of him for some reason.
Dude, that game spoke to me in different ways. Can I have Joel and Ellie? That's not fair. I need to have Joel.
Yeah, fine. I'm gonna go with Ratchet and Clank then.
Oh.
Wait, are we picking favorite characters or
no,
like
picking, you need to,
you're making a team right now.
Oh shit. Well, I was gonna say the guy from Spec Ops: The Line, but he'd probably kill both of us. So let me think. Oh shit. I'd have to say. Oh. I'm looking at my game. Commander Shepard. There you go.
Commander Shepard. All right. So,
male or female? Male or female?
Yeah.
Male, assuming he isn't indoctrinated.
Oh, okay.
So
there's a lot of criteria you had to meet right there.
So my lineup is Spider-Man, Wonder Woman, and Ratchet and Clank.
Man, the Joker, and Joel and Ellie.
And, of course, Deadpool, Lobo, and the guy I just said, Commander Shepard.
Post in the comments who you think would win.
Yeah. I guess, yeah, I don't think we can really decide.
That's too hard.
No.
Statistically, I mean, John's team has a bunch of guns.
Yeah. Iron
Man has laser hands thingies.
And is, you know.
You can fly.
The whole suit thing.
Yeah, that might help.
Yeah. Well, both of my, except for, aside from Commander Shepard, both of my guys have insane healing powers. And
Joel
both
has,
Go ahead.
Okay, Joel has, he has a gun. But if you've ever played The Last of Us, he has like two bullets in it, so it's not much help.
Deadpool can teleport. Lobo has like an interdimensional motorcycle. I don't think you can kill either of them. I know it's a little OP, but I'm just throwing that out there.
Spider-Man has webs.
He's got webs. He can climb.
As long as we're fighting in an urban area.
You're set.
He can definitely climb. And then the Joker, I mean, he's just insane.
Yeah, you might talk someone to death.
Yeah.
Torture them a little.
Doesn't have much. He's smart, though. He's really smart.
And yeah.
For me, I have one Roman, so S.H.I.E.L.D. with a whip and a nice butt, you know. That works.
Yeah, I guess.
I think John's team wins.
Probably.
Ooh. Yeah.
I didn't even know we were competing.
that was part of it. But yeah, post in the comments who you think would win.
And our third question comes from Amir Xbox One. What was your worst overall experience with Fallout?
Now, overall Fallout, not Fallout 4.
Yeah, just overall Fallout, okay. Like any specific time.
Shit.
I have a good one. It just came to me too. I loathed my like first 8 hours or so of Fallout 2. Turned out to be a good game. But there were so many times, like, I died and, like, I just couldn't progress and, like, I just kept getting stuck and there were so many fail safes. Like, I just, like, looked up God mode tutorials. Like, how do I just beat this game and be done with it?
Yeah.
Like, I had to keep pushing myself through.
It's the time we live in. That's why. If you played that, I guarantee if you played that game way back when, it would have been probably fantastic. It would have blown your mind.
Yeah.
But now, it's like, yeah, it's a good game, but did it age well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, I agree.
The stories and the characters and shit in that game are awesome. Yeah. I had one of my, actually, like, my basically favorite location of all the Fallout games, MODOK. I fucking love MODOK.
Yeah. Oh, that song, though. That song. Yes.
That's mainly why, but, like, it kind of, like, captures the atmosphere of the place and, like, all the characters there. Like, you can see Harold there and stuff. It's awesome. I think also that's where the Poseidon Energy Facility or some shit is, and then you can get to the Angry Enclave prank call.
Yeah, oh, wait, dude.
Who the fuck? I'm going to kick your fucking ass.
Yeah, that's hilarious. Apparently, if you actually wait there, they actually come and kick your ass, too.
That's amazing. Really? Yeah. Oh, my God.
For real? Like, I got to check this shit out.
If you wait there, they actually come. And
I thought they did.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I just that sent a Verdi assault team. Usually they just come in shooting.
Yeah, yeah.
I love it, though. Yeah,
that's great.
But, yeah, what I was saying, though, is that like, getting used to the games and stuff. Like, I got through Fallout 1 pretty easy. That's a relatively short game, especially if you just focus on the main quest.
Yeah.
But Fallout 2 was considerably, like, bigger. It was really weird because they only had, like, a year to make the game or so.
Yeah.
But yet it was so much bigger.
There's, and they
so
cut a lot bigger out, too, if you look at the behind the scenes. Yes. But even then, it was phenomenal.
Yeah. So, for me, it was just, like, getting past that, like, everything is so tough.
Right.
Couldn't stand it. And then, like, getting killed by companions. Like, especially that part where you're at, oh, fuck, I'm gonna get killed for not knowing the location.
Rip.
Not the oil rig. It's right before the oil rig, which it's hidden in, like, a gas station-like area.
Hmm. I'm not thinking of it.
Fuck. What is it? I think it starts
with a long time.
V or something like that. Whatever. It's loaded with Enclave. It's a secret Enclave base.
Oh, okay.
It's part of the story, and oh, my God. Because you go over there and get, like, vertebrate plans or something like that.
Right.
And, oh, God. It was torture. Everything just destroyed me. I had to, like,
because
there was an elevator that you ride to the top to get to the place where you find the vertebrate plans. And it's loaded with every type of Enclave. So I literally kill one, go back down the elevator, come back up. They'd all reset. Like, I had to break the game to get past it. I couldn't do it. So hard.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's fucking sucks.
Yeah.
My most hated Fallout experience was playing through Dead Money at all.
I love Dead Money.
Oh, God.
I don't get it. I think it's just, and no offense to you, John, I think that anyone who says, oh, dude, why does everyone hate on Dead Money? I love it. Like, hipster. Straight
forward. Oh, I understand why people dislike it. Like, I can totally see why you would dislike it. But I personally totally enjoyed the experience. It was the most atmospheric that New Vegas got for me. Like, New Vegas was not very atmospheric, and Dead Money was for me. But that was for me.
It builds an atmosphere, but I hate the atmosphere that it builds. Like, so.
the difficulty spikes fucking bullshit, though.
Stupid fucking radios that, like, like, turn on your collar and blow your head up. Like, who sat at a table and said, this is a good idea?
Yeah.
Who said that?
Just mechanics in general that, well, first of all, why are some of the radios covered? Why, if one is covered, why won't they all be covered? But, like, I just hate everything. It's so linear, first of all, like, everything about it. And I understand a lot of the DLCs are linear, but this one was, like, especially linear for me.
But in comparison, like, Honest Hearts was fucking awesome.
Oh, my God. Lonesome Road was
I fucking hated Honest Hearts.
Lonesome Road was, probably my favorite.
Yeah, Lonesome Road was
favorite. Actually enjoyed Honest Hearts?
Oh, no, Honest Hearts was fantastic.
I personally thought it was garbage, but that was just because it was boring. Like, it was all the same. Lonesome Road was great, but it was super linear. Old World Blues was just phenomenal, in my opinion, though.
Mm. Wow. That 30-minute start, that's the only thing that bothered me about it.
I wasn't a big fan of Old World Blues. I liked it, but it
I liked it for all it added.
Because it just wraps up the narrative. Like,
oh,
beautiful.
Dude, Lonesome Road, that was so...
Lonesome, like, his voice is like chocolate.
Yeah,
Ulysses. I would restart scenes just to hear him again. I know that sounds really weird, but I love his voice.
Like, did you know that? I actually figured this out sort of recently. Ulysses is actually stalking you while you're there. Like,
wait, what?
Yeah, you can find, like, there's certain areas when you're there that if you scope in the right spot, exactly, you can see him sitting there watching you.
What? Oh, it's like G-Man
watching you and shit. Yeah,
it's like G-Man. That's so cool.
Yeah, like, he's actually stalking you while you're there. So that, when I figured that out, that's,
I thought he was spying on you. I thought you meant, like, he was spying on you through, like, Edie or whatever. I figured that much, but I...
Yeah, like, he's actually watching you. And he, weirdly
that's
enough...
That's spooky.
Yeah, weirdly enough, that Ulysses that watches you is actually a different Ulysses that you fight at the end. They're two different
characters. Wait, what? Oh, so it's, like, a different created in-game character.
Yeah. It's they're not... They're, like, meant to be the same person, but they're in-game, they are two different people.
Huh.
Yeah. It was actually really cool. I liked how when you nuked whichever side at the end of Lonesome Road, it changed the map too.
Yeah. Yeah.
Spoiler alert.
I do hate that you can't reap the rewards of both. I don't hate that. Obviously, that's just part of the experience. But
like, yeah,
you can only nuke one of them, and you can't go to the other one.
You can nuke. I thought you could nuke both. I haven't played it. I think
there's an option to nuke like two places.
Yeah, you can nuke both places.
I think so.
Shit.
But you can't get both for rewards. Like if you nuke both places, you get a different. Because like you know who you nuke, you get different items when you leave.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I nuked the.
I think one of the best parts is when you nuke whatever. I think if you make the right choices, and you nuke wherever, and then you leave, and then you come back, you find Ulysses like sitting on the edge of the cliff, like his legs hanging off. He's just like watching the divide.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Guarding it from whatever.
Yeah.
And like you can
talk. That was intense.
Like, he's a super badass character. Awesome. Like everything about him, it was just amazing.
I love him. Yeah. Remember when we were talking about our worst overall experience with Fallout?
And then we.
Yeah, we're bad. We're fans.
It's really hard. This is really
it's
tough.
It's hard to talk bad about it because even though I hate Dead Money, John, he loves Dead Money. So, like, you can't. It's hard to.
That's the great thing about Fallout, though, because everybody has their own experience and everybody experiences it differently.
Yeah.
True. So, what do you not like then, John?
About Fallout? Save corruptions. Like, not anything specifically in-game. Maybe the Chinese pistol, because why does that exist? But, save...
Three damage.
Still more effective than Chinese pistol. But no, I've had some save corruptions that have, like, set me back. Especially in Fallout 3. I've lost, like, 20-plus hours of gameplay.
Yeah, I could understand why that would be...
That would probably have to be my biggest irritation, especially because I'm an impatient bastard, mm-hmm. and I hate redoing stuff.
Yeah, so. I've actually never had a save corruption.
Same. You are lucky.
Hold on, let me find some. Okay,
there we go.
Yep. Nope. Not jinxing myself now. I've done make sure so well.
This is real wood. There we go.
I know the feeling because that happened with me with out of all games, Hitman Absolution. I think it was because Noah told me to clear my save cache or something, and I think I accidentally like deleted something. I think that's really what happened, if I'm honest. But I know for a fact I lost my save file at some point there, and I lost so much, like 16 hours worth of progress.
That's so unfortunate. I was at the
bitter end. I was like, "Fuck this! I'm not doing that over."
There's been a couple times where I'm just like, "No, I'm done. I can't." Like, I refuse to continue. The game beat me. There have been times where the game has beat me.
The game won.
Our final question changes it up a little bit. Yeah, this one comes from Jay Mead on Sugar Bombed, and last time we answered his question. It was about our first crush. He wants to know about our first real relationship when we were like,
"Oh, will God you damn, be
mine,"
dude.
And it all worked out, and geez. Then unfortunately ended like all,
like every single first relationship does.
Yeah, I almost said like all relationships do, but I'm like not all, but like
not everyone.
But like the first,
just
one.
The vast majority.
Yeah, most of them.
We'd like to go first.
All right, I'm not gonna start this one. I gotta think about this one.
I mean, mine's a pretty good story.
Go, I want to hear it then.
Oh, yeah, you go first, definitely.
It's not like all gloom and doom for me. I mean,
oh, mine's...
Mine was, so, I think this is around when Skyrim had came out. It was been out for a couple months, and so my channel grew a little bit, and so that's kind of like how people knew me at school. They knew me as like the YouTube guy, I guess. Other than that, I was a fucking geek, but...
Same.
I am, yeah. Wow, you just hear that ever faintly.
Yeah, yeah, ever like from the room. He's like, room.
You still are. Fades out. So yeah, that like, my channel was growing at that time, and so this girl who was in my like video class was asking me about my channel and stuff, and she seemed relatively interested. Which like I don't want to say no girl has ever not been interested, but she had like a particular even to this day I'll say very unique interest, and she like understood everything I said because she was very video inclined and stuff. I was like, damn. I like this girl. So I was like, well, she has a boyfriend, so whatever. Yeah. It was a snow day, so went home early. And, like, later that night, she, like, IM'd me on Facebook. And stupid me, you know, she has a boyfriend. Clearly not a sign.
Yeah.
She was hitting on me pretty hard, though.
Right.
And I found out that she, quote, accidentally sent me a text of her breaking up with her boyfriend at the time. But it was, I found out later on it was intentional just to... giving a sign that, you know, hey, I'm single now.
Hey, I don't have a boyfriend.
I thought was really sweet. You know, I thought that was, you know, in the moment, I thought, like, that's kind of fucked up. Like, but, like, you know, when you look back, but
that's actually, like, because it's intimidating as a guy. Like, is it okay to ask? You know, do I wait?
Yeah, you know, it's so difficult.
So I was like, you know, that was really awesome of her. And so at that point, I found out later on, you know, things happened. You know, she liked me, I liked her. But this is where things got interesting for me. And this is where, I guess, the story takes a turn for the, I don't want to say the South, because I really, it's probably my fondest relationship, if I'm honest. Not because it was my first one, but just because it was such a good one. But for a couple of months, we had to, like, keep it under wraps because she didn't want to hurt her ex's feelings for jumping into another relationship so soon.
Right. Understandable.
Which made sense, obviously. Yeah. But for me, I'm sitting there like, I mean, I guess this is the immature part of me because, you know, I'm in 11th grade. I'm like, are we going to put a title on it? You know, we're dating, obviously. Like each other a lot. We are boyfriend and girlfriend, but
Wait, you didn't have your first relationship till 11th grade?
Yeah, like I'm saying my first real one. Like I've like kissed girls before.
Well, okay, like you had like slight
ones. Dude, I took them to the fucking movies and did nothing with them. Yeah, like all that bullshit. Yeah,
No, I get you. Never mind.
Yeah, but like I consider in 11th grade that's my first actual like dating for extended period of time.
Yeah, yeah.
And so, you know, like she like we kept like arguing because that like literally the relationship was borderline perfect in my opinion because we never argued, got along with everything, always had a good time. But just any time we argued, it was because of that same thing. It was like, can we just put a title on it? Finally, like 3 months later, like, yeah, went for that.
Wow.
Yeah. Finally, happened. We dated for 6 or 7 months. But yeah, like, we went to, like, prom together and stuff. Over some... it was a really good relationship. Unfortunately, it ended pretty bad, but, you know, it was...
Right.
That's often how high school relationships end, though.
Yeah, like it was a borderline train wreck, especially more so because it was my first relationship.
Borderline train.
Oh yeah, that's all.
The reason I say borderline train wreck is there's a little cheating involved, perhaps.
Oh my god!
And I found out through a YouTube message. I found out from a YouTube message, so I was kind of like, oh, you really didn't just tell me. Like, I don't care what anyone says. I'm a nice guy. I'm a forgiving guy. I don't hold grudges. Just tell me.
YouTube message.
Yeah.
That's savage.
But you know, her and I are like, I mean, like I said, I forgive. I'm not gonna hold a fucking grudge over a relationship.
It's whatever.
I'm very good friends with her, love her to death. You know, she's an awesome person. But you know, that was like one. That was like my overall first relationship.
Yeah,
I learned
that's
a lot from
that. That's a bad way to end a first relationship too, because then you go into the next relationship a little bit on edge.
Yeah. That took until like a couple months ago. So I was well over the edge.
The edge was not sharp anymore. Yeah,
the edge is not sharp.
The edge had
dull salt. I'm just hanging there.
All right, I'll take next one if it's okay with you.
Oh, definitely.
My first real relationship, I would call it, actually was in freshman year.
Oh, and stud over here. Beat me out by 2 grades.
Yeah, I beat you out by 2 grades, fam. I had relationships like back as far as back as like 8th grade, and they were pretty serious, but I don't count them just. Because I don't. I only count high school relationships. But anyways, all right, give me the specific question again so I can answer it correctly.
It was literally just talk about your first real relationship.
Oh, okay.
Because we talked about our crushes last week, so.
Oh, okay.
Continue.
I'll continue. And she was a girl I knew through my church, and which is, oh God, I feel like that's a really bad way to start one. But she was actually really cool, and we got along really well. We had the same kind of interest, you know, gaming and whatnot. And we dated for, I think, 12 months. Not 12 months. It was like 11 months. And there was some miscommunication. Our relationship, it kind of degenerated into more just physical. It wasn't really a real relationship anymore. So it ended pretty poorly.
This guy in freshman year. Damn.
It ended pretty poorly.
I couldn't even imagine. I was sitting there playing MW2.
Same. Well, actually, okay.
But no, it did not end great. We're on talking terms now. But it was for a first relationship. I think it went at least for the most part. It was really good. Certainly not as bad as some first relationships I've heard of. Thank Christ.
Yeah.
Because I've heard of some pretty shitty first relationships.
I know mine sound like. I guess mine could have come across as like sounding bad, but really, in my opinion,
well, I mean, very but good. If you don't include the middle parts, that usually means it was a good one.
I'm sorry, but there's no happy ending. Like, oh, it's so good that it ended. This
high school, I guess that's relationships don't end happy. Like, I have never heard of a happy high school relationship ever.
Yeah.
And if it ends happy, you're going to end up like screwing around or getting back together, and then it'll end poorly.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't think it can
happen. Yeah, basically, yeah.
Yeah, my first relationship was, okay, when I was like 13.
Oh, dear God.
I went to karate a lot, like a lot.
Oh, shit.
Okay. Oh, shit.
So, needless to say, I was pretty good. And, I didn't pay to go to karate. I worked at the karate school to go to karate. I didn't get paid money, but okay. I got to do it for free. And the way you work at the karate school was I would go directly after school from, I got out of school at 3:00. I would go at 3:30, and I'd be there till 9:00. Basically,
training your ass off.
Yeah, the first certain amount of hours was helping with the kids class, and then. Well, the little kids class, and then the kids class, and then I would be in the, quote, adult class, but that was just, like, after 13, 14 years old, you were in that class.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. And then I got to, like, the demo team, and that's, like, we used to do demonstrations, that was how you advertise it. But yeah. I met her from the demo team.
Oh, okay, cool.
And so we obviously had quite the similar interest.
Both kick ass.
Yeah. And, I mean, it lasted.
Dragon Ball.
I think at that time I was 14 or 15. I think 15. And I mean, it lasted like 5 months.
That's good.
Nice.
For that age, I guess it's all right.
Yeah. I'm in a 2-year relationship. It's freaking me out. I'm like, yo.
Yeah, no, that's fun. God, I can't even imagine. But like, yeah, like 5 months. And like, we didn't even, there wasn't like, we hung out after karate, like not in karate too, but like our main thing was like in karate, we would just talk all the time and it was great. But it just basically ended from just, we don't really want to do it anymore. I don't know. It's hard to explain.
Yeah,
we,
no, that's how a lot of relationships.
Yeah, it just didn't feel, we would rather be friends than.
That's smart.
Yeah.
I support that fully.
That's good. So. That's a good ending.
That's actually a good ending. And
I guess you proved this.
Wow.
One.
Yeah.
I kept waiting for something to go wrong.
Like for me, because you guys are all talking about getting in relationships when you were 13, dude. I was such a choke artist when I was 13.
Oh my God.
I'm not saying this like to sound egotistical. Right. I'm anything but that. But when I say, and I wish Noah were here to vouch for me. Two girls I talked to are now like that I talked to at that point are like some of the hottest that went to high school. And mind you, they were not shallow people, but they were willing to give me a chance, and I fucked up so bad.
I think everybody's still done that to this day.
My friends and I joke about it. That like, happened when I was 13. I am now 20. That's how badly it's, quote, haunted me.
My thing is, I had some girls that I like back in middle school that I dated like temporarily for a short time, and they were okay looking, but they weren't great looking. And now they are just smoking hot, and they want nothing to do with me. I'm just like, God damn.
No, like the only.
Well, it's because they're smoking hot now, of course.
The only reason I was able to even like go out like be with her is because we went to karate together. Like in school, I would not talk to anyone. I just went to in high school. I went to my classes and everything, and like I had like two friends. One ended tragically, but like I had like two friends, and I hated it. I just never got into like the whole high school scene and everything. So
no, I'm the same way. I don't have any. I don't want to say I don't have friends at high school, but I'm not part of like any high school scene.
Yeah, I only talked to one person from high school that I went to high school.
I couldn't really technically be a part of a scene. I made YouTube videos, so there was no.
Yeah,
I just like to befriend everyone. That kind of worked against me though, because then girls would come in. I'm like, oh damn, let's go, and she's like. We're friends. I'm like,
oh yeah, like I liked everyone. Like I didn't have anyone I didn't like. I just hated being there. I don't know. There's something about it.
Yeah, I mean, in retrospect, I didn't like being at high school. But like once high school, like I walked out from my final day, I just stood there and stared at the building. I was like, fuck.
I'm doing the same thing. I'm in my last year, and I know that if I don't take advantage of it a little bit, I'm gonna regret it. Okay. So I'm trying to at least slightly enjoy it while I can.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just enjoy the freedom. College is pretty.
It's like free, I don't have to have a blast, but I'm not. I'm trying not to take it for granted or anything.
Now you have an advantage then, knowing that. For me, it was.
By the way, like, I actually got my black belt in karate, so you know.
Oh shit.
Oh mind. Fuck! Remind me not to make you mad.
You know, yeah,
for real.
Yeah.
Personal I should radio bodyguard.
Official.
Man. Well, that should wrap up this week. By the way. that should wrap up Woo. Everything. We talked about everything.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Wow. That was a good one. Thank you, both of you guys, for joining
anytime.
Me on such anytime. Short notice.
Anytime.
I want you guys, the listeners, to give some special thanks. You see their Twitter handles on screen. Go thank them, because they literally, I shit you not, I hit them up like 30 minutes before we started recording this.
Yeah, I had just gotten home and got on my computer. I see Maddie. Hey, man, what you doing right now?
I was like, bro, you free? Yes.
Stuff in his
app. Yeah, damn right.
Yeah, I was like, Cody, like, what are you doing right now? Absolutely nothing. Hey. I'm like, good. You're going to be on the podcast.
Good.
Have fun. And I got a plug. Check out our lore episodes that Maddie and I did on his channel. They're fucking sick.
Dude, they actually have, like, blown up since then. It's actually pretty crazy.
Yeah, no, it's great. I love seeing all these new people learning all the lore stuff.
Yeah, it's awesome.
That's cool.
Brotherhood Archives.
Brotherhood Archives.
I almost said Chronicles, because I did Vault Chronicles way back. And almost,
except you just like word for word re-spoke the wiki. Yeah.
Oh gosh!
Don't I'm bring that. Throw up, you man. Under the bus.
Don't bring that. I was gonna say, don't bring that up.
Word
man.
For fucking word, the wiki.
The wiki. But that's the thing, though. I didn't hide that, though. When people were like, "That this was just the wiki," I'm like, "I know." And then I look back at that, like now, like new Maddie, and I'm like, "Why did I think that was a good idea?" I'm like, "What was like?" I will just read word for word the wiki. Until, like, later on. Then I started, like, rewriting shit in my own words and learning it myself by going in the game. But it's too late at that point. Yeah. All right.
Well, like actually, I don't really do this much. I'm going to plug myself.
Oh, go.
Okay. So, I'm like, I have a reason, though. I'm, like 75,000 followers on Facebook. Hmm. But I want 100,000.
Oh, my God. I'm jealous.
So, like...
I only have 6 or 7, I think.
Make 100,000 happen?
Yeah, go.
Get your shit together, Maddie. Goddamn.
God.
Slacking.
Yeah, you're at like 8,000 something.
No one uses fucking Facebook, in my opinion. I could be wrong. Though.
No, but the only reason I go on Facebook is if I need to message my mom or if my girlfriend's kicks off.
I go on Facebook for woman research. Because no one thinks about it, and I'm just like, okay. Facebook, like, put that name in there. I'm like, all right, let's see what you did a couple of years ago. Start going through their uploads.
Look, I like to post stuff on my Facebook, but I also know like businesses and colleges are going to be looking at that shit. So I'm just like,
I don't know how people do that. I don't know how people just post on Facebook like pictures every day and stuff like that. I used to when I was
in middle school.
Life. I struggle enough to post like twice a week on Instagram or something. I barely get
it. I used to have a great Instagram
somehow,
that got banned.
I somehow still get like 5 Fallout related photos a day on my page, but like as far as my actual Facebook account goes, I would never post anything on there. Are you kidding?
The fuck are you talking about?
Like,
who would like to close this one out?
You can have it.
No, you got that. I'm sure.
All right, I got it. All right.
You got that. I'm sure.
Fuck! I just close it out. All right.
Come on, you got this, man. You got this.
You've been watching the Ham Radio podcast with a bunch of white guys.
Bleached edition.
The Bleach edition, not the anime. Come back next time.